The following program is intended for mature, adult audiences. Viewer discretion is advised. You have been warned.
Okay, so like, everything started off like in cult, and it was my birthday, right? Oh man, you should have been there. We were at the Dragon's
Roost. It was your birthday?
Yeah. So it was my birthday, and that's when I got all my stuff. Like, you see my armor and my bow and the really cool cutlass that I have? Those were all like really cool presents that my parents and all the people of cult got me. So like, it was my birthday, and we were eating all this really good food. And then Captain Fairweather came in, and he was like, "Hey, I heard you want to leave town, and like, I have my boat leaving tomorrow, so like, get your ass on there." And I was like, sure thing, aye, Captain." And I gave him like a really cool salute that Queen Maya taught me, that she would come down to the docks every once in a while, and her and I would talk, and she tried to recruit me for the Navy like a couple times.
You know.
Like, I'm really good at it. Yeah. Oh, right. So then I left the ship, and they tried to sail around that big storm, you know, the tempest. And it didn't work, and everybody drowned, except for me, because, you know, I can breathe underwater. And then I met the Ozide, and he took me to Douglas, kind of. Unfortunately, though, because I was underwater, my legs kind of fused back together, and I ripped my pants. So when I got to Douglas, I didn't have any pants to wear, so I had to find a guy who then told me where the pants store was, but he gave me some really bad directions, so I ended up at, like, an apothecary, and they gave me directions to somebody, but that somebody was just, like, a regular, like, leather worker. They didn't have any, like, actual pants there.
Nope.
But then I finally got directions.
Is the pants thing relevant?
Okay, so I got pants, and I went to the inn, and when I got to the inn, there's this guy, but I walked in the inn, I punched him in the face. Turns out that was Quincy, really good guy. I'm kind of sorry, Quincy, that I did that. So then we went upstairs, and we met with some really cool people. Well, okay, but then I had to go get the pastries from downstairs that we were having for breakfast and bring them upstairs.
We don't need to talk about the pastries. It's fine.
Well, okay, but then I accidentally outed Wrath as like a vampire, and I still feel bad for that one too, so that's kind of 0-2 for me. But then I went back upstairs, and there's all these famous people. I don't really know who they were. One of them was like a princess, and one of them was like some lord or what. I don't know. Anyways, they gave us these missions of like, some people had to collect crystals, and some people had to like go to the moon or something like that. I don't know. I wasn't really paying attention. But one of them had to do with the Bronze Tower, so I was down for that. So I joined this group, and they called themselves the Vitore. So we spent the night in the inn, and then Dream said that night we all had this really weird dream together, but I don't remember it, so I think Dream may have just been making it up to kind of scare us.
I swear to you, I did not make it up.
Yeah, sure. Right, anyways, after the dream, we were decided that, hey, we got to leave Douglas, we got to get a ship and go and try to find the Bronze Tower. But then we left, and we ended up in the middle of, like, this really cold place at this cabin, and then the person inside was really rude and told us to leave because eyes were watching us or something. I don't know. And then we met this really, really tall, super hot lady, and her name was Kelia. I'm talking, like, 7'6", like, super buff, and this big old bear that was, like, 15 feet tall. His name was Igor. Really cool. I met him the next day while he was doing laundry. And that was when I did magic for the first time. And I didn't even have to go to, like, wizard school for it. I was in tune with nature and everything like that. And, like, you know, some of those other people, they have, like, studied for, like, a long time before they can do magic. Okay. So we met the bear, and then Inoki really liked the bear as well. And then we had some stew. No, we had the stew before we met the bear. And then they invited us to do this thing that's, like, the Seeking, where, like, we could have gotten our own bear, but then we kind of got sucked. We heard this bell ringing, and we went to this tower. Turns out the tower wasn't really there. It was, like, a dream tower or something. We got to the top, and we found Drian, like another Drian, but it turned out that wasn't Drian. It just looked a lot like them. We got in a fight with this big goo monster. Inoki threw their sword off the tower for some reason. I don't know. It looked really cool, but it didn't work. And then our friend Alex, who's a Vanai like me, he got absorbed by the goo, and that was really scary. And also, there was a big bright light, and Ziggy disappeared, and that's really sad. But Ziggy's disappeared before and teleported back, so I think they'll be back, but I don't know when. But anyway, so we left the tower running away. We retreated, like, you know, we weren't scared or anything, it was just a tactical move. And then we found this cave that was, like, a secret magic cave that, like, they built from Dreen a long time ago. I don't know, really weird, super magical cave that had, like, a storm inside of it and then this mummy ghost that was inside of it. But they didn't have any food, which is weird. Like, why are you gonna build a place for somebody and then not put food in it?
It's 1,000 years old.
Okay, but you can magic food. Some people just don't understand how magic works.
Do you understand how magic works?
Yes, I do magic. Obviously, I know how it works. And we were in the cave, so we slept in the cave, and for some reason, when we woke up, Kelia slapped me. I don't know why, it was me and the three Canid kind of all sleeping together. It was me, Revna, Destin, Kelia. And then all of a sudden we heard this sound from outside, and like all of a sudden we found Jameson and Acacia just pounding on the wall to the secret temple, and we let them in, and then we decided, okay, we need to go back to the village and try to see if there's any survivors. And we went to the village, unfortunately there weren't any, but we had a funeral pyre for Frosthammer, Mr. Frosthammer, Mr. Lord Frosthammer. And then we decided we were going to go to another village. And then all of a sudden, Dream put on this really weird hat and super cool sunglasses, and these two giant rabbit things popped out of the snow. And they had like a cart that we hopped on, and they took us to this next village. But then as we were going to the next village, this like shiny thing opened up, and all of a sudden we were in the middle of like a forest, right? And that's where we're at now. And it was all like super weird and super fun.
I'm glad you're having fun.
Welcome back to Flavored Enemy Tales of Vitore. This our episode, Arcadia. Last Novatori had left off, we had quite the encounter with the remainder of the Novatori finding themselves in a very large and distinctly different from the frozen north of the cold forest, where they were stopped and spoken to by two fairies who were sitting on a log. And the two fairies had looked at you all and said,
"Hey, it's about time you showed up."
Are you talking to us?
Yeah, I mean, who else would I be talking to? The trees? No, that's only on Thursdays. Well, what you might not know is Thursdays, but we definitely know is Seth Day.
The heck's a Thursday?
It's the same thing as, like a Seth Day, or also known as Brickin.
Drian, do you know what any of that means? Anoki? Gotta?
So this is not where we were a moment ago.
No?
I agree.
Weird that you've been expecting us.
Yeah, I mean, wait. I can get you all cut up if I could have your attention real quick.
Get us caught up.
Is that okay with everybody?
Please. I guess, yeah.
Please and thank you.
Yeah, that.
Oh, okay. Just go ahead and follow us. We'll help you get over to your friends. So, my name's Basil. This over here is Narcissa. Hi, everyone. Good to finally meet you. Kind of been watching you from a crystal ball for a while now.
Dreen, is this another one of your temple things?
No.
I don't know. We appeared in front of a mountain last night. I don't know. I figured this was like one of your people. You have people, right?
No. Do you see lightning around? This isn't me.
There wasn't lightning in the cave or mountain either. It was inside.
You had to use lightning to get it. It doesn't matter. Let's pay attention, Nito.
You just follow us. We'll help you get caught up. So basically, we've been kind of watching everybody, and you know, wanted to get caught up on what all is going on and make sure that everyone's okay. We have a friend of yours here, and if you all could follow us, we could get you all set up back up and on your way. Kind of waiting on you guys for a while now.
Okay. Yeah, what they said.
Sure, of course. So yeah. Then follow us. And they start moving towards the interior of the forest. As they move further along, you can see that it is a very beautiful, serene looking forest. There are fruit that is hanging very low in the trees, and you know, arms reach away. Heading further down, you can actually see where the grove kind of forms this arch that you're able to just walk underneath, this hallway of tree, for lack of a better term. And there are small and extremely sweet smelling flowers that are just flowing in the breeze in between as you guys are traveling through.
Welcome to the Spring Court. It's good to finally meet you guys. Like I said, my name is Basil, and this is Narcissa. Narcissa's, cat's got her tongue right now, so not very talkative.
Well, Basil, pleasure to meet you. My name is Nito. I'm sorry the rest of my friends aren't introducing themselves. They're not very social, but I guess you've been watching us, so I assume you know who we are.
Oh, yeah, of course. I gotta say, I'm a big fan of your guys' work. Gotta say, I am loving all the stuff that you guys have been doing. You guys wouldn't have to be hungry, would you?
Well, I've got my snackle box, so I'm pretty good. I know this one, and I'll point to Drian, they only eat, like, potatoes for some reason, and like raw potatoes. That's what you said.
I said, in the swamp, we do not get very much variety. We have to get what is sent to us.
And you ate raw potatoes.
Potatoes grow everywhere. And what's wrong with eating raw potatoes?
From the swamp? Are you from Bogsboro?
Potatoes do not grow everywhere, excuse you.
Do you miss it? Do you miss Bogsboro?
Why do you care?
I'm just wondering. You know, sometimes, like last time I left home, it was a very long time since I went back, and I missed it a lot. So I was just wondering if you missed it.
Drian, don't be rude. You're making us look bad in front of my new friends.
You know, you don't find any of this at all suspicious.
No, this is what happens on adventures. Don't you ever read any stories?
Yes, occasionally I miss Bogsboro. I do not want to be sent back because I'm in the middle of something.
Oh, okay. Well, here we are. And you guys open up to a clearing. There's a table laid out with a bunch of food, breads, and meats, hams, and hard-boiled eggs. There's crackers and all manner of just things laid out. Big, big barrels of wine and empty glasses. There's also a small table off to the side where there's a bunch of paper that's scattered around, and you can see ink and quills and all kind of manner of notes, as well as a board off to the side where it looks like there's some kind of planning or surveying that's going on. You also see Ziggy.
Well, look what the rabble dragged in. How's it going, friends?
How? You've got to stop doing
this.
You're
alive?
I knew you didn't die, Ziggy. I believed the whole time.
I don't know the meaning of the word. To be fair, I haven't meant to do it either time I did it. But I'm very happy to see you all. Please, make yourself comfortable at the table.
Ziggy, a quick question. Last time I went somewhere that I hadn't been before, I kind of ate food with people, and then I got challenged to fighting a lot, and I may or may not have gotten married. So, like, is there anything that, like, I shouldn't be doing here?
I mean, if you're going to pick fruit or something, ask for permission from the tree, you know? You just, typical manners, stuff like
obviously.
That.
But
partake at our table. You're invited, and I guess if you want to arm wrestle afterwards, I'm always game.
Yeah.
That seems like a Jameson thing.
Yeah, no, we're not like those the Autumn Fae. We're generally pretty nice. No need to worry about anything.
Yeah, these two are harmless. Don't worry about them.
Who's the Autumn Fae?
Oh, yeah. No, those are just kind of like I guess they would say like our cousins.
Yeah, distantly related.
Oh, okay. Oh, like cousin. Okay, yeah. I've got like 47 cousins, so I know what that's like. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'm gonna. Do you mind if so? Some of the stuff that's like maybe like non-perishable, would it be okay for me to like put some of it into my snackle box for later? I noticed you got some like dried figs and stuff.
Oh yeah, go for it.
Thank you so much.
Hey, Zelda Jen, we're gonna go and grab. We're gonna go and grab a. Well, you know who we're gonna go grab.
Yeah, absolutely. Please, Ziggy in front of my friends.
Sorry.
No worries. I just don't want them thinking I'm too uptight or anything. But yeah, let's get you know who.
All right, sounds good.
So, Ziggy, couple of people you haven't met yet.
Oh, yes, please. Introductions are in order.
Wait, at Damaris. This is Damaris, my sister. Hi. This is Nikita.
We got a bear!
Wow. Is this... I turned to Jameson. I'm like, oh, is this the bear cub I was supposed to wrestle or whatever we were talking about before I went poof?
Yeah, exactly. This is exactly that same bear.
I mean, we can still make it happen.
Excellent. And is your sister who I mistook for you in our
yes.
Scrap, we'll say, with Darnser?
My sister, who looks very different than me.
That's me.
That, I wouldn't say very.
You know?
I am going to be honest, I did jump into that because I misunderstood. But, very glad to officially meet you.
It's good to meet you too. Gotta say, a little out of my element here.
Yeah, it's not horrible practice to sort of stay on your toes and be suspicious of others, but I'd say in this very particular spot, take a load off, take a seat, fill your bellies. It's a beautiful place. I'm really glad to share my home with you all.
This is a pretty swanky home, if I'm being honest. So are you like a lord or leader? Like, are you like famous here?
Oh, no. Perish the thought on that one. My parents are kind of up in the bureaucracy of the summer court, and throughout my life have been sort of emissaries to the autumn court. So I sort of rub shoulders with that type a lot, but through and through, don't worry, I'm an adventurer, not a nectar drinker.
Was that an insult?
No. I guess sort of. Nectar is delicious. Do try it, but I'm a little more rough and tumble.
Which one of these? You've got like 17 different things. Which one's the nectar?
Oh, right. So like 6 of them have some form of nectar. There is nectar with a delicious herbal tea. I love florals. I can't recommend the rose enough. There is also over here a sort of a citrusy one. They're all great. Very refreshing.
Do you have any hibiscus? If I'm not being too pretentious.
It's hard to be too pretentious here. Here you go.
Thank you so much.
It's at this point that you all see a very slender-looking man who's very pale skin and almost glittering with this faint white glitter all over his face, kind of just glistening in the sunlight. Shock of white and grayish hair on top of his head. And within the nestled curls on top of his head, you can see 2 cat's ears and these piercing gray eyes. And some of you recognize him from previously.
Oh, well, if it isn't, my friends, say it's a good day to meet you all again. For those of you who don't know me, I am Devlin Barbados.
Hi, I'm Nito Ademi. I don't think we've had the pleasure, sir.
Well, it's good to finally meet your acquaintance, Nito.
Likewise.
So, I am glad to offer you a little bit of solace and comfort within Arcadia. Is there anything I can do to help ease your weariness of the road?
How are you here?
Why are we here?
To answer Drian's question first, I am a prince of the Winterlands, sort of nobility hierarchy of the Winter Fae, and I am a friend to Zildjian. Sorry, Ziggy.
No worries.
And why are you here? Well, I have been made aware of your mission, and, well, I think I may have something, well, at least a lead for you all. Ziggy, would you mind filling everybody in? Meantime, I am going to, and very carefully, secure safe passage through the Autumn Kingdom.
Appreciate it. Yeah, well, thanks for the honors, Devlin. Yeah, Devlin and I are also buddies. Met over the years, and I ended up after I was poofed in the Winterlands, where I was able to reconvene with him. So that was very helpful. And it is through Devlin's scrying that myself and Narcissa and Basil have been aware of your, well, at least some of your movements. We haven't been watching you all the time, obviously. But yeah, so on to why we're all here. Kind of exciting. I have a little bit of parallel growth in knowledge with you all. And it turns out in this pretty odd, I'll say, cave in the Autumn Court, I think we may have found ourselves a Shard of Eternity.
Okay.
Right. This one or the one that you have?
Not the one that I grabbed onto, unfortunately. That one was sort of lost in the process. It's a new one, to my knowledge.
Well, I hate to be that person, but you know, we have, as far as I'm at least aware, we haven't really had great experience with
collecting those?
We need to try, though.
But, yeah, but like, who's to say if we try to get this next one so it'll disappear, you know?
Well, that's kind fair. Of the risk we take being adventurers, though, isn't it?
The other options are
no. Your story is worth reading if it's not dangerous.
I don't mean that we should. I definitely think that we should go get it, but I think we have to come up with an idea as to why Ziggy disappeared. Like, what caused that? So it doesn't happen.
I mean, that's Ziggy a fair just point. Disappears all the time, though.
a lot more recently than previous to that. But it's true. I don't have a full understanding of exactly why that happened. And there have been disappearances related to this one as well. So, I mean, I think we're in for a ringer one way or another.
Well, so I'm assuming that's why we were brought. How did you bring us here? We were like in the middle of like a blizzard. And
oh, that's not on me. Devlin's a lot more competent with that sort of thing, so I'm sure he could fill you in. But I was just told to like wait here and look cool, and then you'd be brought to me, and I'd have a fun reintroduction, which I think went pretty well.
It was quite the surprise.
Yes. Yeah. No, I'm super glad to be back. But yes, I guess long story short, to fill you all in, we're going to this seemingly death trap-ish illusionary cave that most people, if they make it out of, we've sent in a few sort of scouts. Not all have made it out, and the ones who have basically have no memory of the place. So it's steeped in magic.
We just came from an illusion cave. Was it that one?
That's not... Needle, that wasn't an illusion.
There was a wall that wasn't there.
It was a real place with a magical wall.
Yes, I think this is a...
But it was a cave.
This is a cave, but I think it's a far cry from that.
Is that what the survey equipment is for?
Yeah, you nailed it. We've been surveying, and there's sort of a camp set out from there. But, you know, for a larger group of our size, particularly comprised of people who are not court friends, you know, we just need Devlin to sort of secure safe passage.
I was told not to do surveys for courts by my mom. Apparently that's how they get you to do jury duty.
I may be able to help with the survey if you need some extra assistance.
I think that'd be excellent. As for surveys, Nito, I would say, as much as I missed you and your sense of adventure, do not fill out any surveys or sign anything that anyone gives you here from here on out. So listen to your mom, yeah.
Everyone, I'd like to introduce Dahlia Oakleaf, Princess of the Autumn Court. And you see a young, frail-looking fairy with these amber wings on her back and this dark, dark red hair. It's kind of just hanging over her face where you can't even see her eyes. It's a pleasure to meet you all. My body isn't what it used to be. I'm not used to walking. Could one of you be so kind as to give me your hand? She's trying to reach out to make the traverse from her carriage over to you guys.
Ziggy will do it. I will do it.
Thank you, Ziggy. And she kind of floats along next to you as she gets over there. It's an honor to meet you all. I understand you have questions about the cave, Ziggy.
Yes, I suppose the whole lot of us can probably come up with a few queries just to sort of you know, help our upcoming excursion.
Of course.
I guess, yes, I haven't gotten to go into it myself yet, but I guess I can start. Do you know the source? Is it guarded by someone or something that's causing these strange occurrences to the people?
A little over 600 years ago, it started emanating with illusion magic, and as such, it has gotten stronger ever since. And, well, it's become more of a problem lately.
A problem, as in it is the source of problems that come out of the cave, or just for people going in?
Oh, sorry. Say, my young Vinay friend, I'm quite parched. Would you mind doing me a favor and grabbing me a drink?
Of course. What would you like? We've got quite a selection. I'm personally in love with the hibiscus nectar that you have here.
Oh, yes, if you could, please.
And I'll pour them a glass and rush it over.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Of course, of course.
She takes a sip.
Yes, the cave has been in my kingdom for quite some time. And, well, I'm sad to say that we have lost many an autumn fae to it.
That is concerning. I apologize for your loss and, you know, sympathize. I, of course, know a good number of your people from my childhood years. So we know it started, but we don't quite know the source of this magic.
Yes, I believe something within the cave is the source of the magic.
Could it be the crystal we're looking for is causing it?
Yes. I mean, there is the source of... There is a poet amongst the Autumn Fae. She describes it as thus: when the trees and animals are animals and trees, and the river flows into the sea, is there anyone I know who will help dear old me?
I've never thought of rhyming tree and sea. That's really good. I'll have to remember that.
Oh, I know all sorts of rhymes for the sea, if you ever get stuck. You can just call on me.
Oh. Well, this is... I'm sure will be helpful. Thank you. But yeah, I suppose... I honestly don't know too much about the nature of shards. I'm not sure how much more you all learned. I was just sort of caught up by what Devlin knew and from watching portions of what you've all been through. It seems to be something of enough power to do something like this.
Yes, and there are those amongst you who I feel are tethered to these shards more than the others. Say, my young Cosmone friend, may I have a word?
Who is she looking at specifically? Because there are three of us.
She's looking at you, Green.
Certainly.
Good. Would lightning suffice?
What?
The word. Would lightning suffice?
You want to take the word lightning from me?
Yes.
No.
Well,
I suppose you'll have to decide what word it's going to be then.
I'm gonna think it over for a second.
Of course. So, I believe that it's very important that you all examine the going-ons within the cave, but I think the primary thing that you should all focus on is what this all means for the greater picture of Vitore. All of this happening at once, it cannot be coincidence.
No, certainly not. What will you do with the word once it's given you?
Anything that is done with the word.
Apathy.
Thank you.
You are now unable to speak that word in character.
Delightful.
DM, did the... What was this Fae Princess's name again?
Dahlia.
What was that?
It was Dahlia.
Dahlia. Dahlia, if you'd like, these little crackers with, like, the fig spread on it, they're really delicious. Would you care for one?
Yes. I would absolutely love that.
Of course, and I'll bring her a little plate with a couple of them.
Could you do me a favor and get me another drink as well, please?
Oh, yes, and I'll hand the plate off and I'll grab her cup and go and get it. Same thing, or would you like to spruce it up a little bit, try something different?
Let's try something different.
Okay. I was smelling some mint down the table.
Would you do me one more small favor and get me a piece of bread, too?
Of course, of course.
Thank you.
And I'll go grab some bread, and I'll grab a different pitcher. I'll grab the nectar that Ziggy originally pointed out, and bring all of that back to her.
Thank you. You are so kind.
It's just how, you know, Ma raised me, so.
Any other questions about the cave? I know quite a bit about it. I just am not sure what information it is that you seek.
Well, you said that most of the people that... Was it everyone who went in there lost a memory? So we don't know if there's any, like, monsters or traps inside?
Yes. Everyone that went in... Well... The ones who came out lost their memories of ever going in, and those who didn't come out, we haven't seen since.
The people who came out, did they have markings of battle on them? Were there cuts, bruises, slashed armor?
Well, no such thing, but their brains were empty, like a plate of food eaten.
I know that there's certain magics. I just started studying magic, but I've heard that there's certain magics that might be able to, you know, peer into people's minds. Is that... Have they tried that? And what happens?
Mm-hmm. I'm not too sure, really. It seems as though that they're just devoid of, well, memory.
That's very odd, but... What? What? Is it just the memory of their time in the cave, or is it their entire memory that gets wiped?
It's all jumbled, like...
All of their memories?
Yes, it's...
Oh.
It's as if everything is scrambled.
Like eggs.
Exactly.
Oh, speaking of, I did see some deviled eggs down there. Are you a fan at all?
Oh, no. No, I'm a fairy.
Oh. That makes sense.
How many missions have you sent? And what have you learned from each following mission?
413 over the past 600 or so years.
413?
That is correct.
And what preventative measures have you taken each time?
Well, at first we thought that larger groups would work, and that didn't work. So then we started sending in smaller groups of varying races and genders and social classes to see what might work and what might not, and then compiled all that information in this chart here to determine odds of success.
You have a chart?
Absolutely.
Do you mind if I read it?
Oh, absolutely.
You wouldn't mind. Okay.
So,
what is different about us versus previous groups that you think will have a higher chance of success?
Well, you all have been in contact with a shard of eternity, and that is what we assume is causing this. Therefore, you are an unknown parameter. One that has had success. This warrants at least a trial.
Have all of the people who have gone into this cave, are they from here? Or are they from, like, where we were from? Or is it like a mix?
Oh, no. They're from other parts of the Arcadia.
So you've never tried it with people who aren't from here? Or at least from this realm, kingdom, whatever? I don't know what to call this. I'm not trying to be rude.
We have tried with other members from across the realm, all the different kingdoms. And we have hired some commoners from Vitore to come and see if that had any difference, but it did not.
Can I get an insight check on this lady?
Sure.
That's a 23.
You cannot read her. Nothing. There's no facial expression to go off of. It's almost like talking to a recording.
I have another question. You have said that you have sent people from across the realm and hired adventurers.
Yes.
Have you sent anyone from your own court?
Yes, I have. My son went in there and has not returned.
Has not. So you do have an interest besides curiosity then? What is being done for the survivors?
They are being treated for their mental conditions, but I am afraid without any real evidence as to what's caused it, it's hard to rectify the situation.
That's understandable, I suppose. Would it be possible for us to talk to one of these people?
Absolutely. I can bring you to the Autumn Kingdom and you can speak with them there at the facility that is caring for them.
Right. That would be something we want to do. I'm going to look at the rest of the group before we decide to go. You understand that the mission that we're on is also important.
Oh, absolutely. I understand its importance quite a lot.
When you look back at Nito, he just has like a mouthful of Vienna sausages.
What are those?
Well, those are delicious. You should hear, and he's not even gonna ask. He's just gonna put one in Dream's mouth.
Mm.
Chew, just holding fingers to the mouth. Chew.
This seems a bit much.
Hang on, just a second. I have to decide whether or not I'm going to zap you.
Ziggy is standing next to the princess, mortified.
Could I have a moment?
Your Highness. Absolutely.
Thank you. And you, my darling, I don't think I know your name.
And she looks very confused at you, Inoki.
Would it be too much trouble? Could you give me your name, please?
Oh, wait. I tried to make eye contact with Inoki and do a little, like, no, hand signs.
Why?
I love to get to know people, and you're very peculiar. I don't think I've ever met anyone like you before.
Let's keep it that way.
Lacking in the respect department.
They're new in town. I hope you can pardon that, but perhaps instead of them giving you their name, they can just give you something to call them by, if it pleases your highness.
Refer to me as nothing. In fact, you could go so far as to not perceive me. That would be bad, don't you think?
We have a name, but I don't know the language that it's in, so I'm
Ziggy, I'm not too sure. Was there someone speaking?
I look at Anoke questioningly, wait for some sort of thumbs up or thumbs down.
You don't see Anoke.
Do the rest of us see Anoke?
Nope.
Yeah, do the rest of us see Anoke?
Nope. Anoki's just gone.
I walk over to the chair where Anoke was sitting and kind of just like wave my hand through it.
Yeah, Anoke, you get slapped right in the side of the face.
I suppose not, Your Highness.
Oh,
no. There's something here. Does Anoke know magic? I look at Drian, I'm like, does Anoke know magic? Can they
say
turn invisible?
Nito, I don't think it was Anoke.
Say, Nito, would you mind being a dear? Do you think you could do me a favor and fluff that pillow on my seat for me? I'd like to have a seat.
Yes, that the one over there or the one over there?
Please, that one, right over there.
Okay, yeah, yeah. And Nito will make it as fluffy as he possibly can. Is Nikita still there, though?
Nikita is still there.
Okay.
And she has a sit. She sits down.
When would you all like to add to the treatment facility for those affected by the cave?
I think moving along is probably the best thing for everyone, yeah. And I look at the group, clearly a little frazzled.
You see Devlin in the back just has his whole head in his hands right now.
It was his idea to bring this chaos group here. He knows what we're like if he's been watching us. Yeah, I think that's probably best if we move on. Your Majesty, if... Never mind.
Yes? What is...
I think perhaps once they have learned their lesson...
Is there something I can do for you?
I think we're okay for now.
Yes.
Let's wait to settle up what we can do for each other until after my very capable friends and I take care of this cave issue.
Absolutely. Well, if you will follow me then.
So, sorry, Drian, I just we need to be careful.
Yes, that is why I stopped.
I'll go over to Ziggy kind of while we're walking up. Ziggy, the royal lady, she asks for a lot of favors. Is that like a normal thing? Are they just like really used to being served, or?
I suppose it's a mix. If I may say so, I believe, yes, they're partially used to being served, sure. But, I think you were used to get everyone's guard down on questions and favors, my friend. I appreciate your enthusiasm, but as I said, to be careful. It's not your fault. This is a difficult place, and on top of tricks, there are politics to manage.
I don't like ticks.
Yes. There's some big ones out here, so watch for them as well.
And Nita will hold up his hands like the size of like a baseball, something like this big? Or something?
Yeah, like one once was like this on my whole head, like a hat.
Oh, you would look darling in it. We have to get you a new hat while we're here. You would look so amazing in the new hat.
Thank you. I look good in most things, but I'll take the compliment.
You look good out of them, too.
I wink.
I wink back.
So, if you all continue on, say, Nido, I am very much happy for the way that you have been behaving. Have you ever given any thought of whether or not you think that maybe you'd like to serve on the Fae Courts one day?
Well, I didn't even know this place was really... I mean, I heard stories from sailors, but a lot of times we just kind of wrote them off as just that, stories. But I kind of already promised Revna that I would return to Skaldaren and continue nature studies with her. And my dad always told me that when a man makes a promise, he has to keep it. So
sure, of course. I am very much respectable when it comes to promises kept. I believe that is one of the most important things in life. So, I totally understand.
I mean, after all that's, after I'm done studying there, maybe, but I don't know where I'm going to be at that point, so, make another portal, I guess, or get Mr. Barbados to make another portal, and we'll see where we are then.
Absolutely. Say, we have about 20 more minutes to go. And you all feel free to stride along with me, but... Well, I must say, your handling of the situation with Darlingsville was quite inspiring. How were you able to stay confident and calm in the face of such ferocity?
DM, do we remember Inoki though, right? We just can't perceive them?
Yes, you remember Inoki.
Okay. Well, I was most inspired by our friend throwing their sword over the tower wall and just the absolute bravery of just not even needing a weapon to fight such a creature. Just will always stay with me.
Personally, I was immediately knocked unconscious. So.
Everybody's gotta have something.
And you, Child of Lightning, you've given a lot. Do you think it's even possible for you to give much more?
What I have to give is mine to do with what I want, and the moment I can no longer do that, it won't matter.
That I understand. understand. So, are you all enjoying Arcadia?
Yeah, the climate is, I guess, much more agreeable than where we were. Kind of reminds me of home.
It's a beautiful place to live.
It is. I wish there was more water, but, you know, beggars can't be choosers, I guess.
I sense much sadness, a sense of loss and defeat. I am truly sorry that we were not there to help.
Well, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger, right?
False. Doesn't kill you can learn from, certainly. Makes you stronger? Not always the case.
Well, I feel stronger.
At this point you guys realize you're in a boat.
When did we get here?
This may be my bad.
Oh, it's just an interesting change of scenery as you are traveling down a river.
Does this happen often here?
It happens.
Also, DM, is this just like a little like John boat, or is this like sails and?
No, it's almost like a rowboat, but there's no oars or anything.
Gotcha. Okay. Kind of Willy Wonka in it.
Yeah.
Can Zala inspect the water of the river to see if there's anything interesting about it?
Sure.
Perception check, I guess?
Make an investigation check.
Okay. 17, actually.
So it is glistening like molten metal, silvery in color, very smooth and chrome-like. And you can see full reflection in it. It's very dazzling and mesmerizing. If you can make me a wisdom saving throw, please.
Sure, just give me 1 second. Wisdom saving throw, you said, right? Okay. 15.
It is a gorgeous substance. Something that you feel like would make the absolute best tattoo ink. And you desperately just want to bottle it.
Interesting. I ask, Miss Dahlia, was it?
Yes.
I apologize. This water, would it be acceptable to you, if I were to perhaps take some? I like to make tattoos in different inks on this water. It feels, I feel like it has a purpose to that respect.
Well, that which you take must be given willingly. And it is not for me, it's my big respect.
Should I ask the river then?
I think I might be able to help with that. Yes. DM, yes. I'm going to use the special ability of my bow, and I'm going to cast Commune with Nature.
Okay.
And I'm going to ask the river if it is okay if my friend takes a small vial of the water with them.
It's at this point you see what looks to be a dolphin poke its head out of the river at you and boop you right in the nose.
Oh, not my snoot.
Ah, hi.
Hello, friend. Oh. I'm Nito. What's your name?
Wow, there's lots of people here. Hi.
Hi, we were invited here. We're with the princess. And Mr. Barbados, he brought us here.
Oh, yeah. Big fancy.
We had some food. It was amazing. I had the most delicious, like, tiny little, like, sausage things. Oh, my God.
Oh, so yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But sorry, do you know the river that we're currently on? Do you know them?
Oh yeah, I'm the guardian. My name's Frederick.
Frederick, oh beautiful. Like I said, my name's Nito.
Sorry, one second. Am I privy to the nature of this dolphin? Is this thing lying? Can I roll insight as I'm watching this happen in front of me?
Frederick is incapable of lying.
Frederick's incapable of lying.
And you would know that.
I would know that. Do I know that Frederick is in fact the guardian of this river?
Yes, Frederick is in fact the guardian of this river.
Okay. all right, I will not intervene, but I'll be like, Nito, stop saying your fucking name!
So, Frederick,
yeah.
Apologies. My friend over there, and I'll point to Zala, They're really good at tattoos, and I'll show off my shoulder a little bit. And they want to take some of the water here, I guess, and use it in a future project of theirs. Would that be okay? We don't want to take anything that you don't want to give. We always want to make sure that we ask for consent. Nito remembers him shoving a sausage into Trin's mouth.
I totally understand. Well, let's see. Do you like swimming?
I love swimming.
Oh, I mean, like, if you were given the chance, right? If you were given the chance to fly or to swim forever, which would you choose?
Oh, well, I've never flown before, so I don't know which one I would prefer to do. Like forever, but I mean, you live in the water. Isn't that kind of like flying through the water?
I mean, yeah, kind of, but like,
yeah.
Doesn't swimming forever sound like fun?
I mean, it does, but I mean, maybe not forever. I have things that I have to do with my friends.
Oh, okay. Well, how about like if, you know, the last best memory you had was swimming.
My last memory of swimming?
Yeah, like your last memory, and it's swimming. That'd be a good one, right?
Oh god, this is me, the player. I'm thinking back. The last memory that I would have of swimming would be, well, after the shipwreck, probably.
Oh.
Oh.
Nito, I hate to interrupt again, but
but
I just want to make sure you're absolutely explicitly clear that there is a fair to good chance that Frederick here will take that memory that you are trading for water, which may in fact just magically look nice and it could just be water. I'm not trying to be rude, Frederick. You're great. But I'm just trying to make sure you understand things are
I don't understand any of that.
Okay, fair enough. Please carry on.
Well, Zildjian, I mean, if you could spare a second, we could work something out.
I'm afraid I can't spare anything at the moment. I'm already short a moment or two.
I've already written down everything that happened. So, like, I mean, if Zala really wants it, sure, okay.
Oh, okay. Well, here you go.
And he lifts up his nose, and there is just a floating pool of the silvery-looking water right above his nose.
Oh.
Just because I see Ziggy over here is not very happy with the way that I'm doing things, I will say that you will have your last good memory underwater while swimming. You're welcome.
I'll have it?
Yep.
Oh, well, that's nice of you.
Mm-hmm.
Oh boy. Frederick, I'd just like to express I'm not unhappy. I'm just trying, you know, they're new. You gotta understand I'm trying to help my friends understand how things work here.
Oh.
Why
do I gotta understand?
I spent too long on Xanthia.
Okay, but
I'm sorry, this is something I feel I need to do. No flack on you. That's just
But Mr. Frederick, just so you know, me and my friends, we have a bunch of stuff that we need to do here. So you're not gonna get in the way of that, right?
Oh no, I would never deign to get in the way of anything.
Okay, well, I mean, I'll tell you what, since you were so nice, you don't have to put that extra bit on there. We'll just trade the memory for the water.
Oh, well, that wasn't the deal.
Well, deals are made to be negotiated, aren't they?
No, a deal's been struck.
Well, you added on top of the deal, right?
No, I just clarified.
And I'll take the water.
Zella hands Neo a vial to collect the water. One of her empty bottles to collect the water. Yeah.
Do you have a flipper I can shake, or?
Oh, no, sorry.
Yeah. Well, I was just good doing business with you, I guess. Hope we meet again soon.
Oh, I know we will.
And he dives back underneath the water. It's at this point that the river disappears and the boat is now walking with, like, giantly long chicken legs across the land. And then the boat finally reaches its spot and lays down. And the door off to the side opens, and you can see the Autumn Kingdom in front of you. Huge maple trees growing all around with leaves in the various oranges and reds and yellows. And Dahlia gets out and gestures for all of you all to exit the boat as well.
As they exit the boat, Zala, I guess, receives the bottle of mystic water from Nito and adds it to her inventory, I guess.
What do y'all do?
I'll get off the boat.
Yep, I'll exit the boat.
Well, that was different.
Yeah, how's the bear cub doing?
Yeah, for real.
Bear cub is just kind of sitting there, waddling back and forth, trying to get his balance back. See, Nikita's just looks like he's gonna be sick.
Is our imperceptible cat friend here?
No idea.
And I rolled a disbelief.
I'm just gonna go over and like try to console Nikita, like give him little pats, make sure they're not gonna throw up too much.
Zala will accompany Nito and try to gently do a medicine check on Nikita.
Yes. I'm going to take my rightful spot on Jameson's shoulder.
All right. It's 12. Been awfully light since you've been gone.
12 the medicine check.
I can tell the shoulder muscle feels like you haven't been doing your push-ups.
Would like to give this touch of advice, and Ziggy can attest to I don't give things freely. I would not speak with anyone in my kingdom save for those that you are very certain you want to speak with.
I give a polite bow as thanks for the advice, but don't talk.
Nito will copy the bow.
The Autumn Court is a very peculiar place. Words here have much higher meaning than other places. If you all see that building a little bit further away with the red rooftop and the yellow chimney, that is where you will find those affected by the cave. The boat here will remain until the last of you is boarded upon it, then it will take you back to the cave. Are there any questions?
I don't have any questions. Do you, any of you?
Just one for the princess, if I may, Miss Dahlia. I have one question for you.
Of course.
If I may, how close have you been to the cave yourself?
Been at the mouth of the cave, but never further.
Can you tell us if you saw anything?
Your mouth gets sewn shut immediately.
Oh, shit.
I want you all to be careful. Have a good day.
And she walks away.
Is her mouth still?
Yep, it is sewn shut. You can actually see thread keeping the mouth closed.
Zala, if you give me one of your needles, I can work through that, but I can't promise it will tickle.
Zala gently holds up her hand and points to the tattoo on her cheek. And then points from her mind to your mind. Points from her head to your head.
I will touch the tattoo.
Zala activates it. And you can now hear Zala's thoughts. This is my linking tattoo. I got it recently.
Does it have a somatic component? Or a verbal component?
Hold on, let me check. I don't. Let me double check. Shoot. Second. I had the card for it. Let me just reload that. Hold on. Oh, wait, no, you're right. I have to speak the word for it. Never mind.
Yeah,
shoot. Darn it. I guess Zala just politely quickly takes out one of her empty needles and hands it to.
Alright, yeah, I'm just gonna try to gently cut the threads. I don't know if there's a check I need to make for that.
No, you cut all the threads and the mouth opens up. And Zala, you can speak once again.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Ziggy.
No problem. Sorry. That's, yeah, you just gotta be on your toes in this place. It is not necessarily malevolent. It just is.
I would like to make an acrobatics check, please.
Uh-oh.
That'd be a 7.
11.
That includes you two, Enoki, Acacia, Zala, James, and Dream.
Oh, I can back check, you said. Okay, sorry. Okay. Grand. Okay.
Ooh.
I got an 18, surprisingly.
Okay.
I have a 20.
Cool.
Dodge.
16.
Alright. Enoki, Jameson?
13.
Okay.
Enoki, you got a 19.
Alright. Those of you who scored higher than a 12, your speed is not reduced. Those of you who scored lower than a 12, your speed is reduced, as you are all now forced to stand on your tiptoes.
Ah, fuck.
We gotta stop saying stuff. Drian is just choosing to be quiet the moment he sees us. And then walking towards the facility.
Look at me, I'm tall.
The people are.
That we need. I'm taller now. What do you know?
Zala very quietly whispers into Ziggy's ear, does the magic of words here work on telepathy as well?
I shrug. Thinking back to my childhood years and how I should have paid more attention when I was with my parents.
Because I could do that if we needed to.
Well, this shouldn't bother me too much. I can fly. Right, Drian? The shield?
I'm gonna look at Nito and just shake my head. Like, that's not how that works. Walk into the infirmary here.
Okay. You all walk on your tiptoes into the infirmary. And as you get inside, you see that there are a multitude of beds, hundreds of different beds, with all manner of fae laid out in the beds. You see satyrs, you see elves, eladrin, fairies, kitsune. You even see some fae goblins. What do you all do as you enter?
I'm looking for a person that appears to be in charge.
You do see a centaur who is checking clipboards on the edges of the beds and looks to be wearing a cleric's robes. You can actually tell that it's a cleric of the healer, specifically.
Can I do a quick insight check on this cleric of the healer?
Sure, make an insight check. It's me at disadvantage since you haven't spoken to him.
It's a 15.
They seem fairly respectable, definitely fae, and it seems like they're very intent on understanding and studying all the notes. That for the individual patients.
I'm going to approach them. Hello. You may call me Drian. We are the Novatori.
It is good to meet you all.
Estalia
told me you all would be coming.
Did she know?
How may I be of assistance?
We would like to review notes and interview some people to see what we can learn about the effects of the cave.
Absolutely. You are welcome to speak to whoever you would like. Notes for each individual case are on the beds. You feel free to review them as necessary.
I'm going to sort of incline my head. Thank you. And I'm going to turn to the rest of the group. Permission out to everyone, but I feel like perhaps those of you who are better at talking to people should do that part.
Do all the fae here look of the autumn court, or are there a mixture?
No, there's a mixture of winter fae, summer fae, spring fae, autumn fae. There's even some Vitorians who are here as well.
Ziggy will, or I will nod, acknowledging what Drian just said, and I'm going to seek out, see if there are any summer fairies.
Okay. What are the rest of you doing?
Zella will approach the bed of the Kintsugi. Is the Kintsugi awake, or?
The Kintsugi, she looks like she's awake, but very aloof. And she can see she's got this kind of like auburn hair, these auburn ears that are tipped in white, she just looks partially there and also partially gone. Not transparent, mind you. just like her mind isn't completely in the moment.
I will gently say hello to the Kitsune. And just ask her if she is okay to talk to me right now.
Pumpernickel is my favorite.
Indeed. I have a friend who quite loves snacks. Perhaps he has some. Would you like that?
The chicken's the demon.
Can you? What sort of demon is the chicken?
And the walls. The walls are always crying.
I roll perception check to see if I can sense anything particular about her mind, or would that be an insight check?
Yeah, that'd be an investigation, I'd say.
Okay. Sure. 14.
There might be some bit of information to glean from what she's saying, but it is almost indiscernible, whatever she's meaning.
Understood. Zella will just stand there, putting a finger to her linking tattoo. Doesn't use it, but is now just deep in thought, wondering if she should. What's that?
Have you seen it?
Have we seen what?
I like pumpernickel.
I will beckon back to the group for someone to come over.
What do the notes on her chart say?
Yeah.
So the notes on the Kitsune's bed say fractured mind, located within multiple different conversations. Each one seems random, but is always revisited. There is a pivot moment, but never anything further past it.
So it's Acacia who came over to help me, yes?
Yes.
I will ask Acacia. This is probably a terrible idea, but I might be able to read her mind. This could end badly. Do we think it's worth the risk?
I think it might be worth the risk. I'll try to anchor you, but no promises. I'm not good at that.
If you could anchor me and lend me your help, that would be lovely.
You feel a chain clasp around your ankle, Zala. As Acacia, you are transformed into an anchor.
Yep. Saw that coming.
Wait, this ship was transformed into an anchor?
Yep,
into an anchor. Can she speak?
Nope. Can I still use my telepathy?
As long as, yeah, your telepathy, yes. Yeah, you can still use it.
Okay. Through my telepathy, I'm gonna say, yep. I should have known better.
Wait, Zala uses her keyword to activate the tattoo. Wait, Zala asks aloud, Acacia, if you can hear me, do you think is it worth me trying to link with you to be able to us to speak, or do we think it would end badly?
DM, can I still hear as an anchor, or am I just an anchor?
You can still hear.
I will send back. Okay. Well, it's probably gonna end badly. That's kind of a given. Judging by the way that words are working here. Could be fun, though.
I guess my question to you is then, you're anchoring me. Does this count as the help action for the purposes of using the linking tattoo?
Yes. I will consider that as the help
action. That's what I was trying to get. Alright. I will say to Acacia, alright, I guess since you're helping me, shall I try to link with the... does the chart say the Katsuni's name?
No, it does not.
I will say aloud to the chain, to Acacia, well, I guess since you're helping me, we might as well do what we were going to try to do. Are you ready to help me as I try to link to the Katsuni? Okay. I'm asking Acacia this.
I'm fine with that.
Okay. So I guess I use the keyword for the linking tattoo.
Okay.
On the Katsuni.
What is the keyword?
Just the word linking. Yeah. Okay.
So as you link into the mind of the Katsune, you see a dark corridor. There's condensation all over the walls, thick, foggy. You see in the center, there is a singular chicken pecking away at crumbs on the floor. You kind of look at it, cock your head to the right. The chicken eats one of the crumbs, grows in size, its bones snapping out of it, turning into these kind of spider-like legs. As it climbs towards you, up you, and says,
"Oh!" Oh.
And then you pop right back out of her head.
Oh. Oh. Zala nearly falls back, but I guess is held by the chain. Well. That was certainly okay. Acacia, you're anchoring me mentally. Did you see? Were you able to see what I saw?
Yes, you were.
The creepy ass spider. Yeah.
All right. I guess we'll find out what that means later. But then I asked the Katsuni, I suppose. Lady Katsuni, do you remember the chicken that became a spider?
Loves pumpernickel.
The spider chicken loves pumpernickel?
Hi.
The chicken's a demon.
Oh.
Unsurprising.
I'm...
But why are the walls crying? Do you have any pumpernickel? You're gonna need pumpernickel. The demon chicken loves pumpernickel.
What happens if we give the demon chicken pumpernickel?
Barry didn't have pumpernickel. No, no, no.
What happened to Barry when he didn't have pumpernickel?
Oh, hi, Barry!
She waves across to the... You can see a fairy that Ziggy's kind of hovering over, who is currently playing what looks like solitaire, but with socks.
Is that... That's
is
Barry.
Is he winning?
Yes and no.
I do acknowledge everything that just happened over there with a bit of a sigh, but I turn back and I'm like, I'll deal with that later. I'm going to go up to Barry.
Okay.
And I'm going to say, when the trees become animals and the animals become trees. And I'm just going to stop and see if Barry responds to that.
You know the song. You know the song. You know the song. Is there anyone I know who will help?
Zala will ask out loud. Well, Zella will ponder to Acacia. Should I try to link with Barry?
I mean, it's gonna be a struggle one way or the other. Might as well.
Okay.
I'm saying you wouldn't happen to have a queen of swords, would you?
I do not.
You need swords. Swords is the best suit. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Is there a worse suit?
Oh. You don't want scales. Scales is bad. Scales. No, 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 no.
I suppose Acacia's still giving me the help action.
Yes.
I suppose I'd try to use linking tattoo on Barry too.
You can't make it all the way over to Barry, as you are chained and anchored to that spot.
Oh,
I'll thank Barry, and I'm gonna walk over and say, Acacia, just be yourself.
I would love to be myself.
Acacia, you are now back to yourself.
The range of blinking is 60 feet.
DM, while all of this is going on, Nito is just sitting with Barry and trying to play solitaire with him.
Okay.
Do you have Queen of Swords?
I take my shoes off and I show him my socks. Am I wearing socks that would be the Queen of Swords for him?
You have no idea.
Are either of these what you need?
Go fish!
I'm already... I'm not a... People call me a fish. I'm not a fish. That was all the time.
Go left. Don't go right. Go left. Okay.
Go left when?
When the walls are crying, of course.
Go left when the walls are crying.
Rights to scales.
And we don't like scales, do we, Barry?
No.
By the way, you've got a play over there on the second to the right.
Where? I always wanted to see a stage.
Don't we all?
Thank you, Barry. I'm going to go over to Drian, say, I think we should just go to the cave.
I'm not.
I nod.
Aisha, do we feel we should walk over and I should give it one shot with Barry at this point?
Don't forget the pumpernickel.
Every conversation's going to be dangerous.
The mouth is
not. I'm not saying to not try, but
if I had two people lending me help, if I had both of you, would that be safer, perhaps?
It's difficult to say. Just that is just how things are here. It is not necessarily the doings of any of these folk.
The mouse is hungry. Evens never odd. Turn left, turn right. Square, circle, triangle.
I'm going to ask Acacia if she feels I should give it one last shot. If I should give it one shot with Barry.
Absolutely do it. I'm interested in seeing what
happens. I request that Ziggy and Acacia both lend me their help action while I do this, just in case.
I don't know if we can double down with help actions, but if we can, heck yeah.
I don't have the magical power to help, but I will try.
You see one of the other individuals who you recognize were part of the notes that collectively link both the Kitsune, Barry, and this other individual kind of looks up at you. You see this this fey goblin who's just kind of sitting on the edge of his bed, kind of rocking back and forth, kind of looks up at you all and says,
"Say, you know, did you hear the click and the clack?"
What's this?
The click and the clack, and all we are is ink on page.
Well,
the chicken is a demon. He didn't have a demon, he had a chicken. Click and clack. Ink on page.
Should I try to read the goblin, or should at this point we just...
Green is walking out of the building and just sort of like signaling to everybody that it's time to go.
I follow.
Definitely leaving. Thank
yeah,
you.
Yeah, leaving. Leaving at this point, yeah. Zella is now thoroughly creeped out and doesn't even bother linking with Barry or the goblin. Yeah.
Are we still tiptoeing, by the way?
You are, yes.
Cool.
And what do y'all do from here?
Once we're outside, I'm going to say you don't have to tiptoe.
Who do you say it to?
The group.
All right. Everyone except for Drian, you no longer have to tiptoe.
Thank you. Neither do you.
Thank you.
Drian, you no longer have to tiptoe.
Excellent. Do I get
except for Inoki. Inoki, you still have to tiptoe.
Do I get the feeling that I can undo magic with words here that was done in another part of Arcadia?
Why don't you go ahead and roll me a Arcana check? If Ziggy would like to give verbal advice on the matter, you can roll with advantage. But Ziggy will have to speak out loud in character.
Sure. I will lend help. I suppose does Dryan ponder this aloud?
Or Dryan? No, he doesn't. I don't. I will not take the help from Ziggy. That was a 21.
Okay.
Yeah,
you feel as though, yes, that it could be undone regardless of where you are within Arcadia. Just the strength of the magic and what particular area it's focused in and how it's applied changes with where you're geographically located within Arcadia.
Okay.
Yes, it's starting to come back to me. Rhetoric is important here.
So, above board here. So, like, you're saying, like, some places are more literal or monkey paw-ish?
Yes. And above board, certain geographic locations within Arcadia favor other kinds of...
Gotcha.
...instances.
Inoki, if you are here, you should be perceivable.
Well, Inoki's right there next to Nikita. That's where they belong, right?
Inoki, you are now next to Nikita, completely perceivable. You can no longer leave within 5 feet from Nikita.
Well, that was certainly something, wasn't it?
We're ready to go.
Inoki is a good parent. They would never.
Nito? I'm gonna give Nito a dad look.
Oh. Yes, I'm ready to go. Just as we're walking, Jameson.
Yes.
Do you remember our adventure when we first met?
Sure.
Cool. Me too. That's all.
Nothing happens.
Shit. Okay. I'm going to have a conversation with the princess after this. Just don't let me forget that.
You do remember how we met, right?
I know where I should remember it.
Ah. That's why I've been quiet, you see. You can't, if you don't say anything, the Fae can't trick you.
I should know better. I've been away from home for a little too long. Okay, let's all go to the boat to bring us to the cave, yes?
So, nods.
I will also nod.
Damaris kind of nods at you both.
Zala briefly attempts to link with Ziggy to ask him a question telepathically. You were uncertain before, but do you now remember if telepathy is affected by Fey magic?
Am I allowed to, if we're linked, am I allowed to respond in the
It's a telepathic link, yeah. So we can just talk to each other telepathically while it's active, yeah. Assuming you didn't contest the link, which I'm guessing you didn't.
I would not have contested. Oh,
I will send you the card for this tattoo, so you have it for the future.
Great, yeah. Thank you. I will respond telepathically then. I will say every form of communication that you can use, do so when using it. Do so literally here. I honestly do not have that much experience with telepathy here, but I think assuming the answer is yes is the way to move forward.
Thank you. Zella says thank you and then breaks the link.
Okay. Right, so you all arrive at the boat. What do you all do from here?
I assume we get in the boat.
Yes, I believe the princess's instructions were get in and it'll bring us to the cave. So that's yes. What I do.
Mr. Boat, or Mrs. Boat, I don't know, actually, Boat, I don't know how you like to be addressed. Could you take us to the cave, please?
You all get in, the doors close, but the boat does not move.
If the boat doesn't move, does the world move around us?
No. No, you're standing completely still.
I say we are ready to go to the cave.
Not all are here.
Do we have our pumpernickel? I was told that's
important. Inoki's on the boat with us, right?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm very much here.
Did the boat say that out loud or just to Ziggy?
The boat said it out loud.
Who are we missing?
You look around and Jareen's here, Nito's here, Inoki's here, Keisha's here, Ziggy's here, Zala's here, Jameson's here, Damaris is here, and Nikita's here.
Oh, no.
Does anyone know what the implication here is?
Well, we are missing one person who was at the tower.
You mean Alex?
Nito just nods.
I wasn't scrying constantly, so I don't exactly know what happened. Would anyone care to concisely and literally explain?
Well, Drian, be prepared to stop me in case I say something I shouldn't. That black oozy thing we were fighting kind of absorbed Alex and may have either eaten him or taken control or made him like an avatar. I don't know.
Alex is no longer with us.
So it is not a good idea to...
The boat gets up and moves.
Oh. Well done.
That hurts, though.
As the boat continues to walk back along the pathway that you guys have went on, the silvery water rising up to the boat's edge. What do y'all do?
Don't... You said we're at, like... Where are we again?
You are in the boat right now, and the boat has started moving, the silvery water rising up to the edge, as the boat is now moving along the same path that you guys had left from.
Nobody look at the water this time, I guess. Just... I guess, Ziggy, this boat's just gonna take us where we need to go?
See a small red-headed gnome sitting on the edge of the boat.
Oh, hey, Dring! Somebody asked for me. What am I supposed to be looking at?
He looks over the edge of the boat.
I said nobody, not gnome body.
No, that's my name.
Nobody is your name?
Yep, that's it.
Ah, that is unfortunate. Well, my deepest apologies. I'm new here. I keep forgetting that words have stronger meaning, but if you'd like to go, your presence isn't required here. But if you'd like to stay, you have free choice.
Free choice, huh?
Nobody should leave.
Alright. Bunch of no funners.
That I don't felt like know. A I that don't felt know. Like a slur, didn't it?
And he drops off the edge of the boat and into the water.
Well, I hope he can swim. Do we see him swimming or does he just like...
No, he sinks.
Fuck.
It's fine. I just did not like the implications.
No, you're no.
Of that person doing whatever they wanted. So, I'm going to spend the rest of this boat ride pensively looking ahead in silence.
Nito is going to be filling out his journal.
I am also going to be writing in the journal, and I'm going to look in the journal of note share, and then I'm going to look at Damaris, like... We're gonna have a talk later.
By the way, DM, have we gotten either a short or long rest since we've been here?
I'm gonna say the boat ride. Yeah, you got a short rest.
Cool. I'm gonna spend some hit die. Yeah.
Damaris kind of looks at you, Drains. Is everything all right, Drains?
I'm going to point at the most recent entry from our sister Delilah.
We can talk about it later.
Yeah. And the boat kind of curves a little bit as you see up in the distance. You can see a giant cave mouth near a grove of trees. As the boat kind of sails across the water, walks onto the land, and lowers itself down.
Do you require another passage?
Zala discreetly nods to Nito.
I'm gonna look at Ziggy. Like, Ziggy, you're from around here. You would.
Yes. Stay here until we come back, and then please give us passage back to the spring court from which we came.
Your wish is my command.
Without another word, I walk off the boat.
I'll look at the boat. Before we go, would you like a snack from my snackle box? You put in a lot of hard work.
I do not have a mouth, and therefore am not hungry. Are you?
Am I what?
Ziggy yells back, don't answer that!
I should. And I'm just gonna walk off.
Okay. And you all continue further along as you reach the cave mouth. This cave mouth is about 10 feet across and about 8 feet high. And it is, looking into it, you can see the walls are kind of glistening with this wet condensation kind of just dripping down it. This same kind of silvery color as the river itself. But you can't see much past that.
We turn left. Yeah.
Is what the crazy person on the bed said.
I would trust the shards of their fractured minds.
I wish we knew Kasuni's name now. But yes.
What do you all do?
Is there a sort of way to turn left at this wall?
Well, you're at the mouth of the cave itself. You could have to head further in. You could theoretically turn left from where you're at right now, but you would just be facing the river.
Right. Okay. Sure. I guess. Yeah. I will look to everyone. I would like to physically attach each other to ourselves. If everyone agrees, I'm sure one of us has rope.
I feel like that might get detrimental quickly.
That's fair, but I could also be a detriment to immediately. I'll be split up in some illusion.
So how are you all doing this?
I will happily go with group majority decision. This is just a thought.
I'm a little bit worried about us all being tied together, but
perhaps a buddy system then? Just make sure we're close to at least one person.
I have a buddy. Do I need another one?
No, we have one buddy already established.
I thought Nito just puts his head down.
Well, if there's no strong feelings, then I think we can go in and take the first left is my thought here.
For some reason, you all now regard Nito as that hoe over there.
Nothing has changed.
That's hurtful, but not inaccurate.
Correct. Okay. Into the cave.
Into the cave.
Okay, so you all head into the cave. As you move further into the cave, you see it fork. One to the right, one to the left. On the right-hand side, the walls are completely dry. Leading further in, you can hear the sound of wind whipping through the tunnels. You also see spots of green light flaked across the walls, like polka dots, leading you through the tunnel, some of them hovering midair. On the left-hand side, you can see the walls glistening wet with the condensation from the river. The floor itself covered in moss, and a faint smell of barbecue? What do y'all do?
Barbecue chicken? I believe we turn left where the wall is bleeding, yes?
Yes, let's definitely go left. It's a wibbly wobbly stuff.
Agreed.
I thought it was turn left when the walls were crying, not bleeding.
You're right.
What's the difference?
In the Fae, dealing with the Fae, little differences is everything. Nito thought they were talking about his memory of fishing or swimming. What they actually meant was his last good memory he's ever going to have is going to be a swimming memory.
I do like swimming.
It's a good thing. I think everyone's taken this whole trip here into the Fae courts a little too flamboyantly. No. Yeah, you know what? That is the right word for it.
Yeah, I think you're right. That seems fair.
What do you mean, a little too flamboyantly?
You're playing with the Fae too much. These are ageless creatures. These are creatures that have existed since before your forefathers were born. They know every trick in the book, and they want everything you have, and you're just talking with them and bandying about with them like they're not going to try and steal everything that makes you you.
I only have one father, not four.
That is actually not a bad distinction to make in this particular place.
In this particular place, I stand corrected. But I meant four as in F-O-R-E, but I understand where you could misconstrue that.
But Jameson makes a fair point. And I misremembered. It is the walls crying, as you said, but nonetheless, I My thought is it is this wet wall, if that makes sense.
Jameson, for some reason, your hand is now pointing down the pathway to the right.
My hand? Just like full stop?
It just kind of shoots up out of its own accord and points down the pathway to the right.
I think we go this way, folks.
There is something to be said that, like you mentioned, that it appears things are being taken at their literal interpretation, and crying isn't bleeding.
So now we aren't going to listen to the mentally deranged?
Right, but what they said was crying, correct? I think I just messed up the thought. And this wall with condensation could be, if taken literally, the wall crying. As for Jameson's hand there, I just want to make a point that whatever power is in this cave could not be of the Fae. So we need to be doubly careful. Or we should be doubly careful, that is.
Well, I will.
GM, can I make an Arcana check to see if there's anything magical affecting my body?
Sure, you can make an Arcana check.
It's just an 11.
Yes, that was an involuntary magical effect, but you're not sure about what in particular it was that did that.
Sure. I don't know. I don't know which way to go. I'm not good at finding paths, and you all know that I can't do anything for survival. But I know that every single step that we make in this cave needs to be absolutely the best step we can make, because the wrong step and you're gone. Everything that makes you is scrambled at the best case. I just want you all to be aware that,
as we've seen,
the best case of survivors from this place has been scrambled eggs. So let's fortify up.
Sure. I would like to cast Detect Magic.
Alright. So you cast Detect Magic and you pick up on tendrils of Fae magic all throughout the area. But you also pick something up deeper, like a really potently strong illusory magic that is just emanating deeply from within the cave and just ebbing and flowing like tides, waves cascading through the cave itself from the deepest part all the way out to where you're at now.
Get a feeling of which direction lead towards that.
Towards no, it's kind of like it's kind of like a burst, like an aura that's just kind of bursting out in a uncontrolled wave.
It doesn't like piercing care about through the walls.
It doesn't care about the walls. No.
I'm going to take, or my thought is to take the words of those people at face value, because that is how they must talk there. I see wet wall. My vote is left.
So, Fae magic all around, ebbing and flowing illusion magic. That's what we're dealing with in here.
Right. As the princess said, cave of illusion magic. So we're dealing with layers of tricks.
Indeed. Something, I decide if it's a good idea or a bad idea. That's what I want to say, is guard your minds. I don't know how that would be twisted here. So I think what I'm just gonna do say nothing.
Nito puts a helmet on.
The left path.
So, does everyone follow down the left path?
Yeah, I suppose.
Yes.
Okay. As you all head down the left path, the cave wall kind of narrows a little bit, curving. The moss kind of thick underfoot as you all open up to a very large corridor area. Within the corridor, there is a singular food cart. Nothing else. Behind the food cart, you see a half-orc. Nito, one you've seen before, Gaseous Pete himself, sitting here selling what looks to be barbecued fish.
Gaseous, what are you?
Hey there, friends. You guys looking for something to eat?
We kind of already... Huh?
With the detect magic up, because it lasts for 10 minutes, does Gaseous Pete still look real?
The Gaseous Pete is magic.
You know, that's... Is he illusion magic or fey magic?
He is illusion magic.
This is an illusion.
Oh, it doesn't matter. I wasn't hungry anyways. We already ate at that big table. So, I appreciate the offer, Pete, but no thanks.
All right. Well, if you're hungry, I got some food here. And there's the bread stall over there.
As you point one side, and you see a bread stall where there's just an assortment of different loaves of bread. Dreen, you see that the bread stall is not illusion magic.
Pete, we've covered this before. I'm not hungry. I'm Nito.
Bread is real?
The bread is real. And it definitely wasn't there before.
Oh, I said that out loud.
Is there pumpernickel?
Yeah, there's all kinds of different loaves of bread.
Well, if we're... How did the illusion make reality?
The illusion also seems informed if it presented us with someone Nito already knew.
That could just be...
Oh yeah, Gaseous Pete and I go way back.
This is a dangerous place.
It is.
Smart you are.
Who
said that?
Yeah.
The walls are lying.
And with that, Gaseous Pete and the stall disappear.
The bread stall too?
The bread stall is still there.
Okay. The walls are lying. Or Gaseous Pete is lying.
Gaseous Pete wasn't real.
Informed or I suppose or not. Whoever... Yeah, whoever that disembodied voice was... One of them is lying.
How do we determine its truth?
You know, I've got magic eyes for 10 minutes, and I can do this a couple of times.
Then, by all means, keep the way.
Bread is
Jameson,
real.
You had an idea?
No, I'm not good at this illusion shit, and that's why I lost my temper earlier. I can do a lot of fighting. You give me a good horde of enemies to chop through, and I'm real good at that. And I'm plenty book smart, but you start putting illusions up in front of me, and everything just looks real.
That it does. Okay, well, I'm going to stick to my... No, I'm not going to stick. I'm going to stay on my strategy of... taking what the people say at face value, and I'm going to go look for pumpernickel bread.
Yeah, you find a loaf of pumpernickel bread.
I'm just going to take that.
Make sure... Don't we have to pay for that?
As you pick it up, the room kind of spins, Drian, you pick up a small surge of transmutation magic, but not much. A small surge. As the room kind of spins, and you are now standing in the same size room, but there is a double door on the other side, and in the center of the room is a small chicken.
Fuck. There are no... Are there any,
The chicken an
represent,
illusion?
The chicken is not an illusion. The
chicken is are real.
There, oh. Are there any representations of swords or scales anywhere along the wall, in the room?
Why don't you get me in and give me a investigation check?
Can I help with this since I was playing Socklatair with the guy?
Sure, go for it.
Right, I'm just going to give him advantage.
Okay. One is a 5, and the other one with advantage is a 2. I don't think I've rolled over a 10 in this game yet.
No.
All right, so that's a 5. Big 5.
Yeah, so not too sure. This chicken is the main thing you see in here.
Can I roll an investigation check as well?
Yeah, go for it.
Um, 18, actually.
Nice.
So on the double doors, you see one, there is a downward facing sword, and on the other door is a set of scales. But there, it's a set of double doors. So, like, the left-hand door and the right-hand door are conjoined with being able to open from the center. On the left-hand door is the scales, and on the right-hand door is the sword.
Okay, who told us not to fuck with the scales?
The guy playing Socklatair said that scales were bad and swords were good. Nito doesn't know the thing about the bread.
Rights to scales was also a thing that was said.
What to scales?
Rights to scales.
Rights to scales.
Are we giving the chicken the bread?
Were we told to give the chicken bread?
I think that's a good idea. We were told the chicken likes bread, and perhaps it will not bother us if there is bread to be eaten.
I will volunteer to do it. I do not handle animals good. They're kind of scared of me.
Oh, I'm good with it. I'm good with animals if that's what we need.
Someone please hold back Nikita.
I will hold back Nikita.
All right.
Okay.
So we, is it Jameson or Nito who's taking it? I'll hand it off to whoever.
If Jameson wants to, he can.
No.
I was just voluntary.
I will do it if no one else wants to.
No, I will if it's all right. I'm pretty good with animals, I think.
All right, but remember, it's a demon, and I give the pumpernickel to.
Okay. Hey.
Yes, absolutely.
Hello.
Okay, time out. I drag Nito back. Don't talk to it. Throw the bread.
I will just walk up to the chicken and just gently place the loaf down in front of it. I'm gonna cast Speak with Animals.
Oh my god.
Alright.
Do I understand the caulking?
You think this measly offering's enough to dissuade me from devouring your souls?
I translate that to the group. He says that this is a measly offering and that we... And he might still devour our souls.
Wow. Barry lied?
Should I ask him if there's anything else that he prefers?
Nope. I think we should just try to walk by. Does anyone know what a good door to go into would be?
I vote sword.
Is there more pumpernickel bread that we can offer?
There is no more pumpernickel bread.
I will open up my snackle box and...
Do you seriously think that this is enough? Do you?
Nito, please stop interacting with it. Keep walking. If it follows us, we activate Jameson.
Tell me, do you think this is enough?
I just keep walking.
Of course it's enough.
Inoki, you can't understand him.
Answer me.
Are you all coming to the door?
Can I vibe check what's going on here? I don't speak demonic chicken, but...
Ziggy, he seems pretty persistent.
Okay, so here's where...
You can make an insight check on the chicken if you'd like to, Jameson.
Can I make one since I'm talking to him?
That's a 16 with a minus 2 for a 14.
This is a very angry chicken.
Can I make an inside check at disadvantage because I don't understand anything other than...
Yes.
I would also try that as well.
Yes, you can all incite the chicken.
With disadvantage, I guess?
Yes.
Well, the reason I was asking, it was less of an insight to see if the chicken's pissed off, because obviously we know it is from the dialogue. It's more of, am I sensing the chicken is about to do something to my boy?
Not necessarily, no.
Okay, well, the chicken gets to keep looking like a chicken, and less like a KFC double surprise.
Okay, but hear me out, KFC double surprise. I got a 13.
I don't know. Answering it literally might help because of the Autumn Court magic, but if there's something else illusionary going on here, it may not count. The rules are new in here.
Answer me.
I just keep walking with the rest of the group.
Oh, wait. Shoot,
you should just tell him yes. You should just tell him yes. Be like, yeah, that is worth it. Fuck you.
You don't get to command me.
It wasn't a command. It was an offering.
My apologies. It's been a long time since I've, actually communicated with somebody.
Well, sometimes you just need to talk things out. I mean, you know what? I bet most people are scared of you. How are you feeling?
You know, if I'm being honest, a little lonely.
Is it okay if I give you a hug? I don't want to intrude on your personal space.
You know what? Like, physical contact is, not my bag, but...
Okay, yeah. Well, I just wanted to extend that offer, but I'm empathetic towards you, and... I mean, sometimes it's just... You just need a good ear to listen to. I mean, how long have you been in this cave?
Listening to this, I stopped trying to help Nito.
Well... how long has it been since 304?
304 Age of Shards?
What's Shards?
Okay, don't worry about it. So there's some weird, people are kind of going insane entering this cave. Is that because of a gem or something that's been in here recently? Would you know?
You ask a lot of questions.
Apologies for that.
So this is actually really good pumpernickel, so you can pass.
Okay, if you don't mind me asking, may I have your name?
No.
Okay, well, would you like to join us?
No.
Okay, well... we're gonna go through the doors, alright? So, good talking with you, and I hope that other people come by and that they talk with you as well, because honestly, you're not, you're a pretty good conversationalist.
Yo, Nito, before your magic runs out, ask which door to go through.
Oh, which door is the door that we should go through? Which one's like the safe door, I guess?
Well, if you go to the right, you'll find a fight. If you go to the left, you'll find a door.
Okay, if we go to the right, we'll find a fight. If we go to the left, we'll find a door. What's behind the door to the left?
The left has the sword, correct?
Yes.
All right. Well, that's two sources of confirmation, so...
They push towards the sword doors.
And you all go for the sword doors?
Yes. I am going to open the sword door.
Okay. As you open the sword door, you see this next room. This next room, there are several statues all around with different fey races displayed all around. Each one of them outstretching their right hand. And in the center of the room is a sort of softly glowing purple light embedded deep within the stone. As you get in here, everything seems kind of spinning and swirling. The statues are consistently moving, looking at you. Some of them are crying, others smiling. And the room is constantly spinning, shifting colors, reds, greens, blues, and yellows, bouncing off of multiple different walls, light refracting off of each other, and the eyes of each of the statues mirrored. What do y'all do?
Is my first casting of Detect Magic still up?
No, it is not.
Okay, I'm gonna repopulate that.
And I would like to run an Arcana check. Or would that be an Investigation check? On the room, I guess.
You can make an Arcana check. Okay. So Detect Magic is picking up just way too much. There's like extreme amounts of feedback. You can't even filter through all of it.
It casts a spell and like immediately cover my eyes. I'm just like, this room is a headache.
I got a 16 on my Arcana check, if that helps.
I'm gonna stop casting Detect Magic. I'm gonna just drop it early.
Arcana, there is so much going on here. It is impossible to discern everything, but you do know that these statues are all connected to whatever is beneath your feet in the center of the room.
I relay that information to everyone. In as few words as possible.
What do y'all do?
There's a lot of colors, but how about any circles or squares or triangles?
Oh, you don't see any.
Are there any that could possibly be perceived?
No, all you see are the 9 statues. See, starting from from 12 o'clock of where you walked in, you have... And if someone would like to write this down, might be beneficial. Right from 12 o'clock, you have a fairy. These are all women, by the way. Very obviously drawn or carved as statuesque feminine bodies. So at 12 o'clock, you have a fairy. At 1 o'clock, you have an eladrin. 2 o'clock, you have a satyr. 3 o'clock, you have a sun elf. 4 o'clock, you have a centaur. 5 o'clock, you have a kitsune. 6 o'clock, you have a goblin. 7 o'clock, you have a bugbear. 8 o'clock, you have a displacer beast. 9 o'clock, you have a... 9 o'clock, you have... One second. 9 o'clock, you have a lizard folk. 10 o'clock, you have a troll. 11 o'clock, you have a will-o-wisp. And then back to 12 o'clock with the fairy. With the will-o-wisp, there is no hand outstretched, obviously, since will-o-wisps don't have hands. But instead, there is just this weirdly centric bluish light at the center of its mass.
I will turn to the group and I will ask, do you all mind if I go up to one of the statues and sort of just look at it, investigate it, but that will involve me getting closer?
Be careful.
Noted.
Would you like me to link minds with you while you do so? To be extra support, maybe?
Sure, why not?
Okay. Dulles says, blinking while looking at Ziggy, and does so.
I'm going to fly up to the fairy at 12 o'clock, and I'd just like to investigate. Does it really look crafted of stone? Does it look more like a petrified person?
Wait, the fairy statue, you said?
As you fly up to the fairy statue, you see the hand outstretched, right? Mm-hmm. And on the other hand, centered on the chest, you see the only thing that is not carved of stone. A singular war pick, flat on one side, coming to a point on the other. And the flat hand, the flatted side, is wrapped in this beautiful, intricately made leather. And very obviously used to play a drum of some kind. But it does look otherwise, like it was carved of stone, not lifelike.
And it's in the fairy's hand.
Correct.
I'm going to touch the war pick.
I need you to make a wisdom saving throw, please.
Yep. Should have saw that one coming.
Big money, no whammies.
Okay. 10. Huh?
You are able to touch the war pick, and you just feel this innate desire to play.
Oh. Okay. So, I touch it and I pick it up, and I suppose what I did not describe before is Z's shield that he used to have that was kind of like a frame drum. If you were to look at it now, there are actually... some scales from scale mail now carved into the edges, so it's like a little tambourine. And so I guess you all see Ziggy pick this pick up and start beating on his tambourine. You hear.
And as you do, the stone all from all the statues crumbles away, leaving just these stone carved statues. 9 of them, mind you. You see a diamond, a circle, a triangle, an X, a cube, you see all those things, plus you see a It's like a sphere, not like a circle. The circle one's like flat. This is a sphere. And you also see what looks to be a dodecahedron, or a 20-sided shape. It's even on all sides. And at the very center of the room, now appearing, is a piece of parchment, an inkwell, and a quill.
Oh, we're all just ink on paper. Right. I turn and look back at the group.
Nito just looks at you and shouts, up, up, down, down, left, right, B-A.
I don't see any B's.
Zala telepathically recites the code that they were given for.
Right. And I'm sorry, you said that, is there anything that indicates left and right here?
There is not.
In that case, I guess I will look left and then right. Mm-hmm. And then
you look left and right and nothing happens.
You're stiffer. Okay. I would like to write the numbers, I guess. Well, no, that you're just sort of giving positions on where they would be in a clock, right? They were not actually associated with any real numbers.
No, they were just like positioned in terms of where you walked into the room.
Okay, in that case, I will not, I will not write numbers for what the square, circle, and triangle are. Does anyone? I call back. I'm just going to touch the square, circle, and triangle without doing any left and right stuff if anyone doesn't have any other ideas.
Ask for consent first.
I will do that. But does anyone have any thoughts on left and right?
Maybe from the orientation of which we walked in the room from the door?
Okay, so sort of go left to right. From left to right for more
Ziggy, I'm not gonna lie, I'm not a smart guy though.
Hey, I mean, if I were to quantify my intelligence, it would be a minus one.
Before we get too far with this, I would like to cast Bless on Nito, Jameson, and Ziggy.
Why am I first?
All right. From left to right, in whatever order those three shapes appear, going from left to right, I'm going to mark the square, circle, and triangle with the ink.
As you do, the room shakes around you as popping up out of the ground, almost like a sprouting tree, you see a wicked-looking, decrepit woman, grayish skin and long fingernails, scraggly-looking white hair, and a gray wool hood pulled over her head.
It's time for me to play.
Roll for initiative.
Oh shit!
All of us? Okay.
Oh shit.
Been so long since we had actual combat.
I know, right?
You guys, I didn't roll a zero this time.
I don't believe.
I don't. He's sleeping. Why do I roll? Okay. Wow. You're surprisingly good initiative scores.
Acacia, you're up first, as you see what you can definitely recognize as a hag in the center of this room.
Okay. And Drian, you cast Bless, right?
On Nito, Jameson, and Ziggy. I only get three.
Sorry.
No. I'm just trying to figure out who didn't have it. So Zala, me, and you don't have it because Inoki's not here?
Inoki's here.
Inoki is here.
With Nikita. Here. Within 5 feet of Nikita, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
If Inoki is visually there, then I will include Inoki in the cast.
Okay.
And I will cast Bless. Can I see Inoki?
Yes, you can.
Okay, then I'm gonna cast Bless at a second level, hit Inoki, Drian, Zala, and the Iron Bjorn.
Okay, you hit Nikita, okay.
Yes.
This is also hit yourself.
I only can hit 4 people, so I'm gonna leave myself out of it. And that will be my turn.
All right. So, Damaris is gonna go, and she is going to just immediately chuck her halberd right at this thing. And that's gonna miss. she chucks right past it, and it sinks right into the stone wall right behind as she starts charging at this thing. That'll be it for her turn. She's got an extra attack. Okay, she's gonna swing with her hand axe as well. And that'll hit as she swings right across the center mass with her hand axe, slashing right across the chest. That's gonna be 6 damage.
Nice.
As you see this hag kind of wince back in pain and get ready to lean in for the assault. Damaris now up and close with it. Zala, you're up.
Okay. Grand. I'm going to... Hold on 1 second. Okay. I'm going to, for a bonus action, with the tattoo tool, which is always in my right hand anyway, move 3 ink charges to my trident. So I'll put 3 bedding charges on my trident. How close am I to the hag?
About 30 feet away.
Okay. I hope this isn't stupid. Hold on 1 second. Alright, I will then approach the hag. And attack it with my trident, I guess. What are the effects of Bless again? Does that give me advantage on attack, I think? Or,
It gives you a d4 in addition to your attack roll.
Oh, okay. Awesome. Right. Alright, so let me just roll for attack again.
Or saving throws.
Alright, so try and... Alright, so attack... okay. 1 second. The heck? It's not letting me... Hold on. Oh, hold on, I'm sorry. I'm gonna put my trident. Shoot. Alright, hold on. Alright, that's fine. I'm gonna have to manually add my inventory just for some reason on D&D Beyond blanked itself completely. I have no idea why. So it's a D4 in addition to my usual roll though, right? Okay. Alright, so this roll plus 4. So 9 plus 4, which is 13, plus another D4. So I get a 14. Does that hit?
A 14 will not hit.
Okay. Okay, so I guess I missed then. Okay. That's the end of my turn then.
Alrighty. Ziggy, you're up next.
Okay, and about how far am I?
You are only 20 feet away.
Great. Second question. This... war pick, I assume is just sort of acting as a normal war pick right now.
As of right now, it is acting as a normal war pick. You have not attuned to it.
Right. Okay. Yeah. There's attunement necessary. Cool. All right. It's been so long. I'm gonna rage. as my bonus action, as my wings start to beat furiously in my rage, the vibrations sort of set off my tambourine shield. And I'm going to go and I'm going to after asking the Warpick how it feels about making some different music, I'm going to go hit the hag with it.
As you swing it through the air, you hear it whistle through the holes within the body of the Warpick, making a really haunting and eerie melody as it when it connects on your attack. If it does, it'll make a loud drumming sound. Would you go ahead and roll me to hit?
Great. I'm going to... Sorry. I don't have a war pick automatically in my sheet here. Is it a D6 or a D8?
I added it to your character sheet.
Oh, no kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Where is it?
You'll notice it has an orange lettering.
Maybe I need to refresh. Sorry.
It might not be on your actions. You might have to go to your inventory and equip it.
I see.
Yeah, typically you have to go to your inventory, click equip, and then it'll show up onto your action page, and then you can click the bonus to hit.
Gotcha. Shiza, I'm not seeing it. So I will just...
Let me try to go at it real quick.
No problem. In the meantime, if it's strength, I can just roll d20 and do the math myself.
It just won't take too long. Just give me 1 second here.
Okay. Sorry about that.
No worries.
How's everybody doing today? We're all doing good, right?
I need to redo my D&D Beyond sheet. I deleted my entire inventory.
I hate the Feywilds. I hate them.
I'm having a great time. I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm enjoying it.
Like, this is the first character I've had interact with the Feywilds where they didn't know what they were getting into to start with.
Nito knows what's going on here.
I am glad that all Aldrian has lost is a word out of his vocabulary.
By the way.
Apathy.
Apathy.
This is actually the first time I've been to the Feywild.
But hey, I get to die underwater, you know, where I belong.
No.
You don't know if you're going to die. It's just your last hack.
No, it's just my last ever going to be happy.
Yeah, but my last happy memory is going to be underwater.
But mind you, what it's going to be is we're going to have a nice water scene, and you're going to have a bunch of death flags, and then
we're going to get out of the water.
And then you're going to get out of the water and then die horribly in the next episode.
Just absolutely mutilated.
I mean, there was in the bedtime story, you spent 1.5 years underwater because of that.
Ziggy, I did explode underwater.
It's on your actions now.
It's on my actions now.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. That's a cool name. All right. I'm going to try to hit.
All right, roll to hit.
Ziggy. Oh, maybe not. Oh, all right. That's a 21.
That'll hit.
Nice.
Boom.
Let's go.
That's 7 plus my 2 rage damage, so 9.
Alrighty.
I'll stay up in the hag's grill. That's my turn.
Alrighty. That'll bring us up to Inoki. Inoki, the hag is flanked now.
I'm going to direct Nikita to charge at the hag, Nikita make an attack.
Okay. Are you also following in with Nikita?
Absolutely.
Okay.
It's sort of Nikita's leading the charge, and I'm immediately right behind.
All right. Go ahead and roll to attack for Nikita.
That's an adorable image. Like you two just...
Oh. He's got multi-attack, so one bite with or bite and then claws.
Correct.
It's going to be
also have advantage because the hag is flanked.
He's right. I have plus the 2.
Checks on that.
It's going to be 7.
The poor baby bear, Nikita, is trying so hard, but just cannot get close.
Shit.
And then for your action?
Right. So with Savetsia, mm-hmm. I am going to swing straight for Hag.
Okay.
E16.
So something strange happens when you swing with Savetsia. As you go to cut, you realize you're about to miss, and something just happens very so subtly. You almost wouldn't have noticed. You're pretty sure that no one else in here noticed, but you specifically notice that the blade elongates itself just a smidge, almost like it's reaching out, trying to hit this thing. Outside of your own will being forced upon the blade, something within it is attempting to try to draw the blood out from this thing as it makes the connection for you. Roll damage.
It can be 5 damage.
Okay. It tears right into this thing, and you notice the blood just kind of soaks into Svezia, not even dropping onto the floor.
Oh my.
And will that be it for your turn?
Yeah, that's gonna be it.
All right, Nito, you're up.
All right, so Nito goes to take his bow off of his back, and y'all notice that as soon as Nito takes the bow off his back and puts it in front of him, the bowstring immediately bursts into flame, disappears, and the wood of the bow along the two arcs starts to almost crystallize looking. And then you notice that it kind of has that look around it of like when it's very cold outside and you breathe out, like it has that frost effect to it. And he goes, and I'm also going to cast Ensnaring Strike with this. So his hand glows green as he goes to pull back where the bowstring would be. You just see this ethereal glowing bowstring and an arrow of almost pure ice and wind forms at the front of the bow, and he lets it go.
Alright, roll to hit.
Flaws.
And then I get a d4 to that.
Did we lose Inoki? Oh. Inoki's in the audience.
It's only going to be a 14 to hit.
That'll tragically miss. As it's an extremely cool moment as you let loose this ice and it just crashes into the wall, shattering everywhere.
Let me see here.
Anything else for your turn, Nita?
Nito is just going to move to a corner of the room so that way he is not kind of, we're not so clumped together.
Alright. Jameson, you're up. This hag looks like it, about ready to make contact. This could be the breakfall. You feel like you have this action right here, right now. You're able to do something before this hag gets any kind of attacks off.
All right. I'm going to unsheath the Justice of Urdaz, speaking the command word to light its blade in flame. Okay. And I'm going to run over to join my allies and slash down at her.
All right.
Good to see the blade of fuck off back. I missed it.
Blade of fuck off swings a 21.
That'll hit.
It's telling me, telling the hag to fuck off.
All right, that is a total of 21 damage.
Okay. Can you give me the damage types real quick?
Oh, yes. It is the 16 damage from physical and 5 from the fire.
Okay.
And then if she's still up, I'm going to action surge, double down, and swing again.
All right. Throw to hit.
27 to hit.
All right, that'll hit.
12 physical and... ooh, 2 fire.
Okay. You see that she is reeling in pain from the flames coming off of this thing. Obvious, very obvious that the fire from this thing is completely just destroying her body. As you can see, it starting to melt. As you can actually tell that her flesh seems to be made of ice.
I would like to also make an intimidation check to try and get her to focus on me.
Okay, go ahead and roll intimidation. I will roll a wisdom saving throw in regards
to... That's a 22.
That is a nat 20.
Ah!
So that'll bring us up to the hag's turn. So... she outstretches her hands... and let's see here. Jameson, Anoki, Ziggy, and Acacia, you all will make Constitution saving throws.
Are we still blessed?
You are.
Uh, 17 for Jameson.
Okay, that's 5. A success. That's a fail.
The 3.
That's a fail. I see that nat 1, Ziggy.
Wait, sorry, that was my blessed die. I was muted. It's an 18 total.
Okay, yeah, you're good. So you succeed. So for those of you who succeeded, as DC was 14, those of you who succeeded will take half damage. Those of you who failed will take full. I will give the full damage thus. That is 42 cold damage.
Oh, wait. Can I use... if I use Silvery Barbs, would the hag have to reroll?
You're too late for that.
Oh, damn.
It has to be before the roll happens.
We can. If 42 is it halved?
That is full damage. 42 is okay. Full.
And if we rolled higher than 14, we have. Great.
As this cold just kind of bursts out, you see Anoki go down. Ziggy, extremely hurt. Jameson, also pretty badly dinged up.
I just spit out some, wipe some frost off my face and say, we're just getting started.
And that'll bring us up to Drian.
Bonus action healing word at second level for Anoki.
Okay.
It's a 5. I'm sorry. 7 total healing for Anoki.
No, the word.
Good game.
Then for my action, is there any room around the hag?
So the room looks like basically the whole room is a 60-foot. Is a 60-foot.
Right, is she completely surrounded?
Or no, you can get in.
Get in. Okay. Questions? Do I want to? Yeah, I'm gonna get in there.
Okay.
And I'm gonna hit her with my mace.
All right, roll to hit.
The 23.
Did you actually hit
something? I might have actually hit something, you guys.
Holy shit!
I would like to silvery barbs that for.
Get at it.
Do you actually have silvery barbs?
We canonically cannot let that mace hit.
I'm not wasting silvery barbs for that.
I would like to point out that we are in Arcadia. I could definitely hold you to that.
What?
I had the spell.
You do?
Alright.
Oh, for real?
Dream.
That's seven
damage.
Seven bludgeoning damage.
And that's my turn. Alright. So smack the hag right across the face and she is reeling. You feel like one more solid hit from Jameson and she's down. And that'll bring us up to you, Acacia.
Oof. Let's I kind of want to... Can I move around to help Jameson with the swing?
Yeah. I mean, right now Jameson's already benefiting from advantage with the flank.
I should have been crit fishing. I wasn't crit fishing at all.
Crit fish, man. Crit fish.
I know. What am I doing?
But if you would like to make an athletics check to grapple, I will give a +4 bonus to Jameson if you can beat, if you successfully grapple the hag.
I mean, I'll try it. Okay. I'm a tiny person. I can do stuff like that. I got a six.
All right, let's roll this saving throw real quick.
That'd be amazing.
Oh, yeah, that was a nat one. You grapple the hag.
No!
What?
Let's go!
Full-on headlock. You full-on headlock this hag right now.
Full Nelson this bitch.
That is amazing. I am amazed. Okay.
So
we should just, like, grabs and like, we're going for a chokehold, I guess. Eating is bad looking.
Hit him with the full Nelson.
Full Nelson, go!
That'll bring us to... that'll bring us to Damaris, who is going to grab her halberd off the wall and then use her attack to stab this thing right in her gut. That'll be a miss. Man, Damaris, she's just not having it. That's going to be it for Damaris' turn. Just whiffs right now.
Does Damaris get advantage?
Oh, no, I did not roll for advantage.
No, yeah, because it's grappled, so we all get advantage, yeah.
And flank.
That's still a miss.
Wow.
Zalit, you're up.
All right.
Nita will just look at Damaris and be like, it's okay, you tried your best.
All right, I guess I roll to attack again with the trident, but I guess it's with advantage, right?
Yes.
All right, how do I have to cuss? All right, so I'm just going to have to... All right, because of my sheet being messed up right now, I'll fix it. I promise I'll fix it tomorrow. So I'm just going to roll 2d20 and take the higher one and then add the modifiers, okay?
Okay.
So I'll just do them one by one. God's sakes. I'm sorry. I don't know what happened.
Calm down.
No, I'm not in any rush here,
you know.
Alright. All right. That was a 2 on the first one, so let's hope the second one's much better. Oh god, yeah. The second one is an 18, and that's before my modifiers, and I have a +4 to it, so that's 22, and that's +d4 on top of that.
That will hit.
Really? Wow, 26 to hit. Okay. Alright. 26 to hit, okay. Alright. And then I guess for damage, should we apply the D6 now or after I do the spear, after I do the trident damage? Because the 3D6 happens immediately.
Yeah, you can apply it all together if you'd like.
Alright, well, let me just... Alright, so for the D6, because that's the ink charges I applied before.
Yep.
Hail to the ink charges! 11 damage.
Yeah, 11 damage?
From the ink. 11 ink damage. That's acid damage. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then for the trident, that's d6 plus 2. Okay. Again, it's going to have to be all custom, so sorry about that. And then for the trident, it's 4, so that's 15 damage.
Okay. All right. The hag is extremely messed up right now, barely keeping it together, but Drian and Ziggy, both of your experiences in this regard tell you that this hag could very well heal herself immensely on her next turn if she makes it that far. And that'll bring us up to you, Ziggy.
All right. I'm going to swing with my sweet war pick.
All right.
With flanking, I also have advantage?
You do, yes.
Awesome. Oh, I don't need advantage, baby. That's a crit.
Hell yeah, Ziggy. Finish her off.
Fuck her up.
Ziggy, go.
Roll me percentage real quick.
Percentage.
The hometown okay. hero.
Is that one of the things on here?
D100? Yeah, if you click the bottom left, it's like the fourth one up, D100.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
So close to greatness. 37.
Wow. Right.
That is going to be double damage. Yeah. So go ahead and roll. Go ahead and roll damage first.
Next one. So here is damage. Oh, max damage. That's good stuff.
Oh, you love to see it.
Oh, yes. So
plus two.
How do you want to do this?
Okay, excellent. What I want to do, even though this is going to be overkill now, is kill her with my first war song. As I strike and I see her, in the throes of death, I start shaking my tambourine. And as a bonus action, I'm going to do my Harmonies of Pain. And Ziggy writes really bad poetry. So he says, "Well, the magic travels right down my arm and bounces off my tambourine to do you harm, Many of Pain." And I guess I kill her with the psychic damage.
I would like to take an opportunity attack on Ziggy for that awful pun.
Same.
As your blow connects, you hear the sound of a gong as you hit her right in the head, and then just the entirety of the head just explodes out.
Oh, it's good to be back.
We miss you.
All right. She falls to no longer be anywhere in your presence. There's not even any remains left. What do you all do?
Did anything else change when I touched the square, circle, and triangle?
No, nothing else changed.
All right, I'm taking all ideas.
There's no body left, right?
Don't say that name.
What? No. I was asking outside of game. Like, the GM said the body was gone. Yes.
Yeah, the body is gone.
Okay.
So a lot of the stone crumbled away, you said?
Yes, to reveal the shapes beneath.
Mm-hmm.
There's also the inkwell and quill and the parchment in the center of the room. It has not moved, nor has it gotten stained.
Bizarre. So, Ziggy, you said it was left, right, and then some shapes?
That is what I think Barry repeated over and over. And then the goblin talked about click-clack, we're all ink on a page. But I would very, very, very much be against writing any of our names on that paper.
Good call. Do we maybe have to touch the symbols going from left to right? I don't know. I don't want you to touch things and then get injured, though.
I don't know. I guess putting the ink on them wasn't the answer.
There's parchment and an inkwell. I feel like something should be written on the page.
What if we write the code on the page?
Sure. Would someone with better handwriting than me like to do that?
Well, I mean, Zala does tattoos. They've got a pretty steady hand. If
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Jameson has an extremely elaborate signature for his own name, but other than that, writes in chicken scratch.
Just the most absolute, like, declaration of independent signature, like, massive signature.
Absolutely. Calligraphied signature, chicken scratch writing.
Does Jameson
I fucking love it.
Does Jameson
That's
have a secret
favorite an- thing.
Does Jameson have a secret ancestor of John Hancock?
Maybe.
Like, are we talking like 4-inch, like normal right. script, and then like a 4-inch high signature?
Right, exactly. Right.
Fuck yeah.
Zala is, approaches the inkwell. Is pretty familiar with the ink, but can I run just quickly inside on the ink to see if I can determine anything about it being special? Or chat.
You can make an investigation check on it if you'd like.
I keep saying inside, I mean investigation, yeah. Sorry about that. Hold on, investigation. Hold on. Okay, so +2 to whatever this is, because I do have proficiency. Right, yeah, okay. For some reason it's not showing up here, but I do have proficiency. Oh, no, sorry, no, I ignore that. I hit perception by accident, so sorry about that. Uh, 15.
So the ink seems to be a permanency ink, one that cannot be dispelled. Like, it's not something that, once written with, it will stay.
I relay that information to everyone. I guess, yeah, on the paper, draw a left arrow, a right arrow, a square, a circle, and a triangle in that order. Left, right, square, circle, triangle in that order, yeah.
Alright, could you make me a wisdom saving throw, please?
Sure. Okay, wisdom saving throw? Okay.
Correct.
Of course it's wisdom. Oh, okay, hold on, actually, oh yeah, I have, okay. 10. No, 11, actually. Yeah, 11.
Alright. So you feel a sharp pain in your head and you take 12 psychic damage.
Yeah.
As the ink dries up and is no longer appeared on the paper, it is once again blank.
Okay.
If I look from left to right, I guess just starting from farthest left being whatever it is from the orientation of the room, mm-hmm. what is the order of the square, circle, and triangle?
Well, it's square, triangle, circle.
Ah. Okay. Do we want someone... Zala, I don't know how you're feeling after that, but if you're up to it, you could try it in that order.
Try touching the, in what order? I'm sorry.
Square, triangle, circle. I'd say either draw it or touch it in that order. I don't know which.
I can probably take that hit one more time, so okay. What do we think? Draw or touching, do we think? I guess I'll draw the square, triangle, circle, yeah.
Alright, so what do you draw?
In the order. Wait. In relation to the paper, in relation to where I'm standing, where in the room is the square, triangle, and circle around me?
So it's square, triangle, circle.
Okay, they're around me in that order. Mm-hmm. Okay. Okay, so yeah, I draw them in that order, yeah.
Alright, make me a wisdom saving throw, please.
Okay. I'm gonna guess I fail. I got a 10 this time.
You take another 17 psychic damage.
Oh, jeez. Zala reels back.
Would you like to try to write something else?
I would like to cast Cure Wounds on Zala.
Okay.
I appreciate that a lot. Thank you. Thank you, Acacia.
9 healing.
Okay.
Okay, thank you. All right, so
wipe away the blood that's coming out of the ears.
That works. All right, so I took. Let me just do the math on this one. So I took 17, then I recovered 9. You said that.
I mean, okay. is there anything else you is there anything left you guys like would like to write?
Can I make a check about it?
Sure. Would you like to make a check on?
Well, so there's this like puzzle that Zala's working on. Can I make a check about it to help figure out?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, you can make an investigation check.
Could I use an Arcana check?
Oh, yeah, sure. Why not?
14?
You hearken back to what you were told by not Gaseous Pete, that something about the walls and lying.
Yeah.
And it just reminds you of this whole thing, and you, for some reason you feel like these statues are more of a distraction than anything else.
Okay. I'm gonna put my hand on Zala's hip, about which is I think about as high as I can reach, and I'm just gonna say, I think this puzzle is not a puzzle, and it might be time for us to move on. Valiant effort, though.
Thank you for the healing. I put the quill down, and yeah, walk away from it. Yeah.
Okay. What do y'all do?
Are there any, like, doors or anything in here?
There are not. You're in a lone chamber with no doors, no stairs, no nothing. All that's in here is the statues, the purple energy, the quill, and the parchment and inkwell, and that is all.
The purple energy being what the will-o-wisp was.
No, the purple energy being beneath the floor in the center.
Okay.
Should we investigate that, perhaps?
Can't hurt. Well, maybe it can.
Is there...
Let's check.
Yeah. Alright.
Oh. Who's rolling for it, I guess?
I feel one of our magically aware people probably should.
I have it. I'll help as well, since I do have proficiency in it. I have proficiency in it, so I might as well. Yeah.
I can roll in. If y'all want me to take advantage.
Yeah, I'll give the help action.
Go for it.
Yeah.
Okay. 22.
The purple energy is very impossibly, unfathomably powerful, pulsating with illusion magic, but incredibly hard to comprehend exactly what it is it's doing. Just that it's like eschewing out this huge amount of illusion energy all around it.
Okay, so there's a lot of illusion magic here. Like a lot. Oh, wow. I don't know if that's helpful, though.
Could we throw something at it?
So, what have we tried so far? We've tried writing the code in the parchment. We've tried
writing it on.
Is it worth somebody else touching the statues, maybe? Unless we think the statues are a distraction.
Can I investigate the statues themselves, see what how sturdy they are?
You can make an investigation check.
Yeah, Jameson, see if we can move the statues, perchance.
That's a nat 20 for a 23.
They are completely solid. Like, it would take an asinine amount of strength to break them, and you're definitely not moving them.
All right, I think the statues are just a distraction. This whole room could probably be a distraction if there's no other way through here. Maybe this was just a side thing, and we need to go through that other door.
What was the thing about us being on parchment or whatever? What was the exact phrasing of that?
Like, we're all ink on paper. I don't know if that was exact, but that's about what they were saying. Well, if the walls are lying, I'm going to try to walk through the back wall.
Right. You attempt to do so, and you smack right into it.
Ow. All right, not this one.
I feel like we're missing something obvious.
Probably.
So the Fae often speak in literal... When the Fae speak, a word that sounds like another can be used differently, right? Homophones are a problem.
Would a ceiling be considered a wall?
I don't think that that's... I think we, based on the paper and the ink, we need to look at the linguistic implications of this. And... there's so much illusion magic in here.
There's so much illusion magic in here.
Ziggy, do you want to test the ceiling, or are you not feeling well?
I'll fly to the ceiling, sure. I'll dash if that's what it takes. How tall is it?
It's about 80 feet up.
Oh, God.
I don't know if I could actually... As I fall to 10 feet at the end of my turn, I don't think I could actually make it 80 feet up, right? Yeah, What could we put on paper that is still technically correct?
Wait. We're all ink on paper. Zala ponders out loud. Not that I'd be the one to do it, I feel like I'm too weak. What if somebody spilled the ink on the paper? Without writing anything, just spilled the ink on it.
I would not recommend that. I feel like that's a bad plan. What was that kid saying in the infirmary? Left, right, square, circle, triangle. What if the right is wrong? That didn't sound...
No.
That makes even less sense.
What if right is right? Like paper and ink writing. I don't know how that helps. very tired.
We can try the code reverse order in that case.
So are you saying we write the actual words out instead of the shapes?
Maybe.
Maybe.
And then left, it could be...
Well, most alphabets...
We
write from left to right anyway.
Yeah, we're thinking of right as in R-I-G-H-T. What if it's...
All right. What if we write the word left? What if we literally write the word left?
No, we went left. We went left. And now we need to write.
No, you just said left, right. What if it's
I'm going to go up to the parchment and write W-R-I. I'm going to write square, circle, triangle on the parchment.
You're going to write square, circle, triangle on the parchment?
Yes.
Like
right.
The word.
Out of curiosity, what handed are you?
Ooh. Nito's fairly ambidextrous, but leans towards being right-handed.
Okay. Wisdom saving throw, please.
Wait. Zella's left-handed in the first place.
Where's my wisdom score? There it is. That's a 6!
You take 7 psychic damage. Weird pain tings in your head.
Is anybody here left-handed?
Jameson is ambidextrous.
Can you write square, circle, triangle?
The words or...
First one, then the other?
Sure.
Yes.
I'll write it in my chicken scratch.
Are you writing the words or are you drawing the shapes?
I'll do the words first, and if that doesn't work, I'll do the shapes.
As you write the words, the parchment expands, turning into a set of paper-like stairs that spiral down.
All right.
No, it was left.
Ah, right.
Well, actually, it's downward, but...
Downward and left.
Back in to the left.
What do y'all do?
I'll start descending.
Yeah.
As you walk through, you see yourself turn into like this inky stick figure walking down the stairs.
Take on me.
And you reach the bottom and you see this purple drawn gem just floating in the center of this area. It looks to be blank parchment all the way around except for the folded stairs to your left and your inky stick figure self.
Yeah, I won't be touching any gems unprompted.
We've come full circle.
I mean, there was a circle in the code.
Can all of us go down this, or just...
Yeah, okay. Yeah, you all can go down it. You all turn into stick figure versions of yourself.
I want to stay up top providing guard.
Okay.
I'm going to stay up with Nito. So, Nikita. Okay.
Sounds good.
Okay. I'm gonna get closer to the purple gem and wait for people to catch up.
I'll put on a pair of gloves.
Like to make an arcana check on the purple gem?
Sure, make an arcana check.
4 and 8, baby.
This looks like the very same style and kind of gem as the one that you encountered on top of the tower in Skaldaren.
Ah, shit.
Alright.
Yo, that gem's magical as fuck.
It's not the same exact one, but it's the same kind.
Wearing a glove. I was talking with my mom. Did we talk about how to handle the shards? I don't think we did.
No, you
didn't. The Maris.
You never brought it up.
Can
yeah.
How did you... How were you able to hold on to this?
Well, I just grabbed it.
You just grabbed it. Excellent. I'm gonna just grab it.
Yeah. Are you wearing gloves?
I am.
Aren't your glove disintegrates as you grab it.
Okay, but my me is fine?
Your you is fine. Your glove disintegrates.
I'm gonna put it with the other one I have. Are we looking? Are we still stick figures?
Well, no. So as soon as your glove disintegrates, you're unable to hold it.
Oh, like, okay.
Your glove kind of disintegrates as your hand tries to grab it, but your glove disintegrates before you touch it.
Do you think we can walk out of this paper and then just sort of fold up the paper and take it with us?
It seemed like a lot of paper.
That's true.
There is one thing. Just kind of a thought, really. Well, the gem that I grabbed, right? It was on the material plane, and you know that's where I'm from. Maybe you have to be like from there in order to grab it.
Ah, good
Anybody
point.
From...
I grabbed the gem.
You
God
grab
damn it!
You grab the gem, and as soon as you do, you all appear in the center of this very small cave. Ziggy, you're holding this gem in your hand. This cave is unremarkable. Very, very small and shallow. There is a singular chicken that's just strutting around. There's nothing else inside the cave.
Hey.
All right.
Hey, buddy.
It's a chicken.
Yeah, we did what we needed to do. Oh, before we go, I'll open up my snackle box and I'll be like, hey, if there's anything you want, you know, just take a peck at it.
If that chicken pecks any of them, I'm going to attack it.
No, Jameson, no. Jameson, no.
Any person.
You see the chicken walks over to the mouth of the cave and is just pecking at the edge of the cave mouth.
Okay.
Mm-mm.
I try to...
Mm-mm.
We shouldn't try to leave?
It should. We should let it leave.
Mop. We should let it leave, yes.
We should not. We should not let it leave.
Mop. Oh.
No, no. He's cool.
Mop.
Yeah.
Mop.
I mean, honestly, I'm not going to begrudge chicken murder, but,
No, trust me. Like, I had a conversation with a chicken. He's not a bad guy. Like, he's just lonely.
Just a lonely demon chicken, Nito?
I'm pretty sure he's a demon. Anyways.
Oh, no, he's 100% a demon chicken. But, I mean, he's not a bad guy. He's just, you know... He's bad guy, but he's not bad guy.
Really?
Yeah.
We should go.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, as long as we could leave, let's. I guess I'll try to cover up the gem so it's not just out and about.
Yeah. If you want to just put that away and maybe not tell your fake word about it.
Yeah, no, I mean, I think we should report that the cave has been fixed. And that's all they really need to know. I mean, this is important for our mission to keep, yeah?
I agree.
As you all exit the cave mouth...
I wave to the chicken.
And the chicken waves back.
Oh, no, it's intelligent.
Of course it's intelligent. It's a demon.
Yeah, we had a whole conversation.
As you all exit the cave mouth, you are greeted to a very strange sight. Sitting there is, at the table, is Devlin Barbados, Princess Dahlia, and a 7.5 foot tall humanoid looking creature with stretched out skin and a set of antlers that come to a bone-like cap over its eyes and down its nose like a mask halfway down its face, and this terrible grin on its face like all of the lips and mouth area were carved away to leave just the gum line and the teeth. Terrible yellow, piercing, sharp teeth. And he looks at you and says,
I have news for you.
And that's where we're in tonight's session.
I fucking hate you.
I know. Murder.
I know who this man's is.
Also,
Nito doesn't, but
I greatly appreciate the hints. Gosh darn it.